No harm in giving it another shot. Just have to try again.
What up, everybody? Watcher Prime, Serene Watcher Gaming here. And today, thanks to a little bit of help from our mod with the most who's, I've decided to start a Disco Elysium playthrough. I always wanted to play this game. I played it for a little bit, and then I stopped. And honestly, I stopped because I thought this would be something that would be good someday to play. Because streaming is something we've kicked around for a couple years. And, you know, this is one of those games where I thought would be interesting to stream to. So I'm going to have to switch this for now and then switch back because this the way this game's set up. And right away, you have to select an archetype. So how's everybody doing today? Who's all checking in? Who's all here? How we all doing? I think we're just going to end up creating our own character here. More than likely. Because, you know, why not? Well, of course you are. Okay, so we can adjust our abilities between intellect, which is going to have raw brain power and how smart we are, our psyche, sensitivity, how emotionally intelligent we are, our physique, our musculature and how strong we are, and our motorix, which is your senses and how agile you are. So what should we lean into? I am actually not adverse to leaning into intellect. I feel like we should bump up, maybe take one down from intellect and bump up either our psyche. I would say psyche. Of course, each and every one of these is like really dependent on how your character ends up. So I'm thinking like that maybe. Not really sure. What do you think? I like having senses, emotionally intelligence almost as important as being, just smart. So, I guess we might not necessarily need to be strong, but on the other hand, maybe we do. Don't forget, we're a detective, and we're gonna wake up not knowing what the fuck is going on because we went on a bender instead of doing our job. I'm liking this setup. Okay, so signature skills. Deduce the world. Call upon all your knowledge. Produce fascinating trivia. Practice the art of persuasion. Enjoy rigorous intellectual discourse. Play the actor. Lie and detect lies. Conceptualization. Understand creativity. See art in the world. Visual calculus. Reconstruct crime scenes. Make laws of physics work for the law. Yeah, so you can pick like one signature skill to start. Of course, you get skill points throughout and you could add on. I'm thinking logic. What else do we have? We have volition, hold yourself together, keep your morale up. Inland Empire, hunches and gut feelings, dreams and waking life. Empathy. Understand others, work your mirror neurons. Authority, intimidate the public.
Certified
Ha!
badass.
Knox, thanks for the host, brother. What's going on? Good timing. You could actually start like helping me decide what we're gonna do with this character. Of course, the timing was impeccable. Yep. Woo's in the chat. Give applause. Knox gets applause. Dropping them bombs, post bombs. So we're trying to decide what we're gonna do here. We have no idea like where we're gonna set our first skill point. I think since we tended towards intellect, we should probably select something amongst these. So either logic, encyclopedia, rhetoric, drama, conceptualization, or visual calculus. Oh, thank you for the love. You're like my favorite Swede. Hands down. I don't think I have any Swedes on my fantasy hockey team right now. Or do I? Oh. Anyway, I think we should go for either logic or encyclopedia. No, I don't have Nylander. Who do I have on my team? I got a little pissed off today actually about that because one of my wingers, Kyle Connor, is day to day. He took a knee to knee. And he's undergoing an MRI and he's like one of my steady players. But that's not why we're here, right? I wanted to check and see if I had any Swedes. I'm pretty sure I do not. Canadian, 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 Russian, Russian, Canadian. Few Americans. Is Dreisaitl Swedish? No, right? Or Demko. Those are the only two that I would consider even remotely be Swedish names. Demko sounds more Russian. I don't know. What are we doing here? I like either persuasion, rhetoric, or logic. I actually don't mind Encyclopedia either. Just knowing everything. I'm gonna go with logic. Demko is American? Yes. The goalie. He plays for Vancouver, right? I have him and Lion from Detroit as my goalies. But anyway, let's get into this game. You jumped right in, right at the beginning.
There is nothing. Only warm primordial blackness. Your conscious ferments in it. No larger than a single grain of malt. You don't have to do anything anymore.
So, ancient reptilian brain. That's a part of your psyche. So, just to fill you in what's going to be going on here, when you see something like this, it's you talking to yourself, but it's like parts of your psyche.
Never, ever?
Or simply keep on non-existing? Like, we should just simply keep on non-existing. I mean, this is kind of funny. Just never, ever, ever. But non-existing would be more in line with what's going on here.
An inordinate amount of time passes. It is utterly void of struggle. No ex-wives are contained within it.
No, this game's, what, 21? It came out 2021, somewhere in there? And it was, like, up for RPG of the Year for that year's Game Awards, whatever year it came out. It was a few years ago. This is the final cut. Yeah, think of... It's kind of like... Like cyberpunk done in, like, a Baldur's Gate way. Sort of. You play a drug-addled detective.
Soaking in some lurid acidic sauce, it's bloated and shameful. All of meat surrounding.
Limbic system.
It's a terrible line of questioning, and it will only lead to more awareness of the meat.
The plunge back into fathomless deep, or no, I wanted to know about the X something.
Ex-love, ex-tenderness. It is foolish of you to resurface to the loss. Not after all the damage you've suffered to get here.
The ancient reptilian brain has like a really creepy voice.
Stay. Sail with me through the abyss of Pelagic Zone.
Alan Z, never let me go. No, I want to get off now. I like pain and burning light and wanted things from people who don't want to give them to me. Yeah.
Do you really?
Don't be naive, of course not. I wait to sail the inky blackness until forever ends. Yeah, no.
I wouldn't like it if I told you what was back there. Why'd you think you had to bludgeon yourself into oblivion? Or did you not sense yourself marinating?
Actually,
poured so much on yourself.
I pre-checked this. Most of this game you want to be in.
Did we, Chef?
That one there.
Fear and apprehension. You should ask what's out there first.
Inland Empire, easy success. Fear and apprehension, you should ask what's out there first. Wait, I did this to myself? Tell me what's waiting for me. I don't care, I'm an idiot, a brave idiot. I think I'm gonna go with either one or two. Wait, I did this to myself, or tell me what's waiting for me. I think for Inland Empire, yeah.
Yes, you're one disco mother. There's this giant ball there. An evil ape. And the evil apes are juking it out on the ball. You're one of them. It's basically all just evil apes juking it out on a giant ball.
How big is the ball?
You can't even make out it's a ball when you're juking it out. Not large.
Okay, how small are the apes?
Infinitesimally small. Time for
this duking it out I keep hearing about. What's that?
You picked up somewhere. A part of the presentation you want to take home with you is this. You have to beat the other evil apes in the face. Or you do.
Yeah. That's sad. Or that sounds like something I would like to do. I don't know about that.
Yes, it is. And you drowned in that sadness a long time ago. You lost.
The sound outside. You recognize it. It's a Caprice Commando motor carriage.
And thusly, you wake up. Completely naked. In a trashed hotel room. Looks like someone tore out the tape while the song was playing. Wonder who that could have been. It's rolling empty. I like how you could like barely move. You see bottles in the bathtub, wine, beer, and sweet liquors. Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and take our shirt. So now we're naked, except for we have a shirt on. Oh, now we're fully dressed upstairs. Still naked downstairs. There's our pants. It's not in an apartment. It's a hotel room. He did this to a hotel room. Wind blows in. Okay, so the window stands broken in its frame. Cold wind blows in. We can look out, or we can do visual calculus and assess the damage, which is easy for us. Yeah, that's probably our tie. We'll get it. We'll do visual calculus since it's easy.
The morning light hurts your eyes. It's hazy, but you see the ocean and some war-torn buildings. The morning light hurts your eyes.
Okay, so that's it.
It's hazy, but you see the ocean and some war-torn buildings. The shards face outward. Whatever broke this window came from the inside.
Did I break this with my own hands?
A fine web of scarring covers the back of your right hand. But none of it is recent.
What did this then?
More likely a projectile than a held object. There are no fragments on the floor from pulling a tool back in after impact.
Assess the size of the impact.
It is too large for a bullet, yet too small for a piece of furniture. You're looking for something heavy and larger than your fist. like the green shoe that's on the hat rack in the corner, which, coincidentally, is his friend. Congratulations. You smashed the window with your own shoe. Now you only have one. If you're lucky, you can still find the other on the balcony outside. The door to it should be outside your room.
Maybe it wasn't me.
The cool wind gushes in. Your toes curl up from the cold.
So we have to go find our other shoe. We know that right off the rip.
You hear a jingle. Keys are clinking in the pocket of your flare-cut pants. It says, whirling in rags, on the aluminium key ring.
Yeah, I know, right?
There's a single
key. I have to clean all this shit up.
It should open the door.
Whirling in rags. On an aluminum key ring, there is a single key on the ring. The number is one etched and it should open the door. Okay, thank you. You should grab another drink, man. We're not done partying, right? Magnum-sized bottle of Commodore Red is empty.
This fan has two chain pull switches. One ends in a tiny fan, the other in a light bulb. A truly horrific necktie has somehow attached itself to one of the blades.
So we could go Savoir Faire, which is medium 10, grab the tie. Even chance, almost 42% chance. We can pull on the fan, or you can pull on the light bulb. Do we take like a really, really bad risk at this? And potentially tear that fucking ceiling fan out? It's a white check. We can retry. So let's try it.
You swoop up and catch the tie.
Oh, God.
Snap. It's released from the blade.
Lucky.
What you have in your hand is a truly hideous necktie with four or five different patterns. The knot reminds you of a noose.
Oh, what's that over there? He's still holding his head.
A mirror hangs above a bent and broken sink. In a fierce discharge of masculine energy, someone has ripped half the faucet off. Hot water sprays from the base.
It's like Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. Like, he's trashing the whole fucking room. Surprised the bathroom's not flooded.
Suddenly, you realize you have no memory of the face that awaits you there, underneath the soft vapor.
You're gonna wipe the mirror off.
As you slowly reach your hand towards the surface of the mirror. Abort. You clearly have not thought this through. You won't like what you see there, and you will never unbecome it.
Okay, so should we still wipe the mirror and look ourselves in the face? Maybe I should touch it first, make sure there's nothing wrong with my face. Better not to know and leave. Oh, we gotta see our face, right? Does anybody disagree with that? I highly doubt any of you disagree with the fact that we should see our own face. But please, feel free to tell me if that's the case. Yeah, that's what I thought.
Behold.
He looks like really young Santa Claus.
You have no idea who this thing is, do you?
Dear Lord, help me. What is this? Of course I do. It's, is it some kind of superstar? I think I'm a superstar. Or this is the face of a late stage alcoholic. I mean, you know, I feel like we should just be honest with ourselves here. And go ahead and say that that would in fact be the face of a late stage alcoholic.
Too late. You clearly have rigor mortis on your face. Oh wait, is that an expression? Are you trying to make an expression with that face? Why?
I'm not making it. The face is making it itself. I have no idea why it's there. It just is. Yeah, I guess that would be more philosophical, right? Two.
Please stop. It's horrible. You're scaring yourself.
No, keep making the face.
You can't, anyway. It's like it's not even voluntary anymore. You have worn that grin into your face, and now it won't come off. What does it even mean? What is the emotion you're trying to convey?
Superstardom? God, I don't know. It's indescribable. I think it's supposed to look suggestive. I'm afraid it's meant for the ladies. I'm insinuating that I'm vaguely sympathetic. I think I'm sort of pulling it off, too, in a sad has-been kind of way. There is some charm to it. Or it's expression of pain. I'm thinking one of these two, either three or four. Either it's suggestive and for the ladies, or it's a sad has-been sympathetic kind of charm. But probably for the ladies to be funny, or if we're going to be serious, sympathetic. I think we're going to go sympathetic.
There might have been 10 years ago. It's little more than a cadaverous spasm now.
Wow, we got a formidable encyclopedia. Dig deep in your mind to locate the source of the expression, which is only a 28% chance. Or we got electrochemistry, impossible, attempt to stop the expression from happening. Or leave the mirror be for now, and I think we're going to be forced to leave the mirror be for now. Because there's no way we're going to make that roll. And you can come back to this later. This is your hotel room, so you will come back to it. Look at Mr. Headache Man trying to make it to the door. Wait, what's that? Our other shoe, first of all. Right? Just making sure we get everything here. Look at how slow he moves. He does get faster. He's just really, really screwed up right now. So what was that we were under that we needed? Not Inland Empire, right? Encyclopedia is going to be the next one we're going to want to do, I think. Empty cassette case, huh? No tools. No interactables. We have a key. Have to use the key, I believe, right? What's this here? Right. Wait a second here. Don't I have to put the key into my inventory? Weird. Oh yeah, it's gotta be super late there. Yeah, see you again soon. And thanks for the host. And thank you for stopping by. We'll check you tomorrow. There we go. It'd help if I went for the right door. Ooh, there's 40 cents on the table. Yeah. Don't leave your money laying around.
Hello, officer.
Oh boy. There we go. It says March, the year is 51. Hey, Jays, what's going on?
The young woman raises a cigarette to her lips. Her eyes are brown, and her face is speckled with birthmarks.
Not much.
She can't be more than 20.
Thanks for popping in. Officer, am I military personnel? Turn your bloated face away from her beauty. And just keep on walking. we're going to ask questions here.
No.
Wait, I know. I'm a businessman. Chief executive officer, right? Well, then why did you call me officer? Yeah, we'll go with that.
Because you're a police officer, sir.
Are you sure? You're shitting me. Goddamn right. I'm a policeman. And don't you forget it. I think I should just say you're shitting me.
I'm not. Unless you've been shitting us all this time.
She takes another drag. All this time?
You've been here for 3 days. On official police business, no less.
And what business is that?
Didn't say. In truth, so far, mostly drinking.
You have no doubt about the drinking. But do you strike yourself as a tight-lipped drunk? She must have heard something.
I might not know where I am or who I am or what a corpus canema is. How I know what one sounds like. Why don't I remember being a cop or anything else? Who in their right mind would let me be an officer of the law? 17% chance to suggest. Think we'll go with 2.
Could it be because of the drinking?
She raises an eyebrow. The cigarette sizzles. So you can't do that. She won't let you do that. So now we can go with either I might not know where I am or who I am. That's kind of weird. Well, we'll do it. Why the hell not?
She nods.
But I do know when someone's not telling me the whole story. What am I doing here? What's my case? Yeah.
There's a mercenary out back. He's been hanged. Body's been there for a week now. Locals probably got tired of it and called the cops.
And why didn't you just tell me that?
I didn't mean to overwhelm you with information. You seem a bit lost, officer.
I might not know where I am or who I am. Well, we already did that one. Hi, Tim. Who in the right mind would let me be an officer of law?
Don't be so harsh on yourself. You let almost anyone be a police officer.
So we can't... We're not going to do that either yet. We're not going to do a suggestion on her because that's like an automatic fail.
Of course. Be careful, officer. They don't like the police around here.
Oh boy.
Something stirs in you as she's about to go. Call it an instinct, a need. The need to ask questions. It's like you said the words a million times before. She looks back at you, a light glinting off her eyes.
What if I don't want to ask questions? Before you go, I have some questions for you. yeah, I like asking questions. What is it that they have against the police here? Where exactly is here? Where am I? Tell me, is it 51 now? Your room is almost next to mine. Did you hear anything last night?
The dock workers are pretty cocky. They think they're police enough. At least here on the coast. I can't say about the rest of the city.
Okay, so where is here? I'd like to know that.
You're in a hostel, sir.
Oh, it's a hostel. I'm sorry. It's not a hotel. It's a hostel.
We are in Revachol.
Revachol is the disgraced former capital of the world, divided into zones of control under foreign occupation. Half a century after a failed world revolution, she is central to our moment in time.
Should that mean something to me? Revachol forever? How about you tell me something else instead?
You sure look like you're from Revachol. Revachol parties.
Her accent suggests she is not from around here. She's from Aranye, another part of the world.
It's 51.
What century?
The current century? Centuries don't have numbers. They have names. And this is the current one. Civilization has existed for 8,000 years, sir. You're right. There is nothing funny about civilization.
Wow, that's pretty, she like a Debbie Downer. Did you hear anything last night?
The usual ruckus. Loud disco music. I couldn't
visitors?
Say. It's impossible to hear people speaking from over here. Oh, yes. Various artists. Ostentatious orchestration prime among them.
She raises an eyebrow, waiting for the name to connect with you.
Oh, that. Yeah. Whoa. The less said about O.O., the better.
O.O. were huge where I come from. I was very young then, of course. Like, 7. Life gets hard, but we go on.
Yeah, we go on, all right. It mostly just gets hard, doesn't it? Do we want to be pessimists? Or do we want to be like, indifferent? I would say this is indifferent. This is pessimistic. Hi, Ivy. What's going on? Thanks for popping in on the Twitch. Yeah, I think we're going to go that route. That.
At around 2:00, the disco stopped, and there was a change of pace.
What happened?
A slow, sad song started playing, like organ music on repeat. That went on for quite a while. Some of the time, you were yelling along to it.
Was I singing this? Show her the empty case of the smallest church in Saint Sam. What was I singing? Yeah.
Yes, there was a church in there. A really
XP.
Small church.
Give me that XP.
Like the smallest, saddest church in the whole world. It was about that. And also...
What else?
That it doesn't matter anymore and that we're alone now. It was difficult to tell. The song itself was very quiet and soft, but... You sounded like a wounded boar. So it was hard to understand.
A wounded boar. Thanks, lady. I'm sorry, when you say wounded, do you mean that in a cool way? Like a wild beast? Then what happened? Yeah, I don't really feel the need to be a smartass. Even though that's probably what I would say. Are you sure I was being assaulted? That's so me. What did I do? You're making this up. I would never behave like that.
A window was smashed. Tape player, probably. The song stopped. And furniture, too. A real destructathon. There was screaming. Then I think you passed out.
Was there anything else? Please tell me there wasn't anything else. It prides me to hear this. Tell me there was more. Hey, Melantro. Thanks for popping in. Yes, you're finally catching me streaming. Although you've been in my streams before. Please tell me there wasn't anything else.
There was. I think you screamed that you didn't want to be this type of animal anymore. I may have misheard, but it was sort of memorable. I went out afterwards. Everything was quiet by then, around 4 or 5. And that was it.
Okay, you can go now.
Glad to have been of assistance.
Yes. She takes it, you know. She does not like these beans. She'll be very happy when they're gone. Matter of fact, I was just saying earlier, yeah, there's only a few left. So. Yeah, I know. I've eaten a bunch of them. I think Serene's probably had about 25 to 50% more, though. Go down the stairs. Yeah, Nox, we over on Kick had to eat a couple. Pretty funny. Now, isn't there supposed to be, like, a sliding glass door to outside? Like, right here? So we can get our other shoe, because I don't want to be talking to people with only one shoe. A gust of wind washes over you. There we go. Yay, we're fully clothed. I did a little bit of it, yes. Yes. But I stopped playing when I realized that if I ever wanted to, if I ever got into streaming, that I wanted to stream it. And here we are. Probably, you know. I bought it as soon as it came out on Kick, whenever that was. Which I know was like a little bit after it released, a year or two. A big old karaoke mic just waiting for somebody to sing into it. The speaker is connected to the radio. The music is seasoned with static. No, you only get one. Across all platforms. So. Of course, there's a couple people that followed while we were off stream, I noticed. Drift Spartan, Country Nick, over on Twitch, and Cheesy Jokester, earlier, probably because I was talking to him in another stream, and Kuna over on Kick, 5 hours ago. So if any of them ended up in chat right now, I have, since that was technically during my times, I would have to eat four. I got like four on back order. But I'm not even sure we have four left. I'm not really... Oops, I zoomed in. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. But yeah, I do owe a couple people. Accidentally zoomed in, sent my controller down to my lap.
Stands behind the counter, inspecting a stuffed seabird. As you approach, he gives you a sideways glance, then looks down again. That was disdain in his eyes. Even now, he's purposely ignoring you.
Something tells me you don't like me.
Oh no, you're a hero. A real hero.
Could the massive property damage upstairs have anything to do with this?
So not only am I a cop, but I'm also a hero. You're being sarcastic.
Am I? Or did you ride in, take the body down, solve the...
Yeah, Serene doesn't like that, and frankly, it's not that great. I did throw up once because of them, so I'm cool with changing our challenge to something else.
No, you see, actually, you didn't. You haven't done anything even remotely useful since you got here.
What have I been doing then? Have you seen me around?
No, I haven't seen you around. I'm not always here.
He looks down again and keeps plucking at the bird. Something told him, well, we already did that.
A competent work of taxidermy. The white and brown seabird lies among piles of coasters and drying mugs. One of its wings broken. The man is trying to mend it. Looks like the bird was ripped off the shield that was used to mount it, most likely on a wall. This is the great skua. The seabird is the symbol for the discovery of the Insulindian Isola, the part of the world you are in right now. Something about it makes you feel bitter.
Look, your buddy is over there.
He looks at the doors where a man in a bomber jacket is tapping his foot on the door.
Why don't you go or floor. And talk to him, okay?
He pretends not to hear you, concentrating on the bird instead.
No, I'm not the bartender. I'm the cafeteria manager.
A competent work. Looks like this is the great skua. Something about it makes you feel...
Look, your buddy is over there.
Okay, that's all he's going to say to us.
Talk to him.
He pretends not to hear you.
The juicer? Somebody's using the juicer? Sign reads, mess hall reserved for union members. Doors open, 1600.
Hello, sweetie.
Lena, the cryptozoologist's wife.
You shouldn't keep your colleague waiting.
She nods toward the man in the orange bomber jacket.
A bespectacled man in an orange bomber jacket is tapping his foot on the floor. Looks like...
Well, it was the two of us, and it lasted like 3 months, so... Yeah.
As you approach, he narrows his eyes.
That's how he made it through the tub.
In greeting. If an assault were launched on this building right now, if the windows came crashing down and the whole world descended upon you, this man would hurl himself in death's way to save you. You are sure of this, but why?
Shake his hand.
Hello, I'm Kim Kitsuragi, Lieutenant, Prison 57. You must be from the 41st.
You realize he's waiting for your name. This is your chance to come up with a really good name for yourself. Get creative. Conceptualize.
Yeah, let's conceptualize, right? Why not?
Concentration makes
winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Your name should be deep gold and orange, like a forest fire looming on the horizon, but mixed with the stench of liquor rising from your breath. You're two steps closer to it, but there are still many to go.
I don't really know my name.
Okay, then.
He processes the information, then disregards it.
It looks like we had a little scheduling error on Sunday. Saturday too, actually. Have you had time to talk to the manager here?
What he means is... He has been trying to meet up with you for 2 days, but you have been
Otherwise occupied. Otherwise occupied. Partying your fucking face off. You mean him? Nod toward the cafeteria manager. Yeah, I just talked to him. No, I haven't. There must be some kind of a misunderstanding. You're taking me for someone else. No, we're gonna...
If you don't mind, we should talk to him again. Ask him for a rundown of the area. Now that I'm here as well. I understand the scene is out back, right? It also wouldn't hurt to assure him the police are finally here. In full force, I mean. Have you mapped out the initial interviews? Good.
We're gonna bullshit him.
We'll have time for that after we take a look at the coroner's case. Have you removed the dead body from the tree?
Dead body? I don't like dead bodies. Look, man, you know. Yeah. And no. And then completely. I'm just gonna say no.
So, the body is still in the tree.
This is the first time you detect a weariness in the lieutenant's voice. It is obvious he would have preferred for the body to no longer be in the tree.
Where it has been hanging for 7 days. We should go there as soon as we are done talking to the owner.
What if I told you I'm not really a police officer? How can you be so sure I'm from the police? But I can't remember anything. What were we supposed to do again? Let's get going then. I go with I can't remember anything.
I drank last night and the night before.
Yeah.
I'm still drunk now. But I have seen
I didn't play it for a long time, babe. I played it for, you know, a few hours, that's it.
If you need something for your headache, there is a general store nearby. But as I said, the dead body should be our number one concern. We all feel that way sometimes. There is no such thing as a police officer, I'm afraid.
What hey, who's...
dead body in the tree. Someone has to figure out who put it there. If we don't, no one...
Thanks for joining in. If you're just joining us now, fam, any of you, we are playing Disco Elysium. We have come to the realization that we are a filthy drunk bastard who wrecked a hostel room. And we don't remember who we are.
And then, soon after, dead bodies would be dangling from all the trees.
Oh yeah, and we're a detective.
But first, we have to take it down. I was sent here to meet a detective from Precinct 41.
Oh, Kitsuragi? Yeah. Militia
on your sleeve and on your back. I suppose you could be impersonating him. You could have gotten the insignia from the black market or forged it. But for now, I'm going to set those possibilities.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Knox hosted us, which was awesome of him to do. Which reminds me, and I will remember as soon as the stream's over, I'm going to have to. Or even when I go on my first break, internal affairs. I'll go on a break and then post up that he did that. From the rat squad and isn't supposed to suspect good friend. Such things. You mean the Rat Squad. You mean Internal Affairs.
Yes, but I'm not them. I'm from Criminal Investigation.
You said insignia. These white rectangles, you mean. Point to your sleeve.
Yes.
But they're just white rectangles.
They're not just white rectangles. They bear a halogen watermark with the letters RCM and a pattern resembling the street grid of Revachol West. I would ask you to step into the headlights of my motor carriage. But again, it's none of my concern. I just need you to do your...
But shouldn't I have a badge or something?
You mean you don't have a badge?
It was not on me when I woke up.
Losing your identification card is a serious matter. My vehicle has a shortwave. You can use it to report your badge missing. I would advise you to locate it as quickly as possible. But getting the body down should still take precedence. After you, officer.
All right, so interview cafeteria manager, inspect the victim's body.
Lieutenant Kitsuragi is now in your party. You can talk to him whenever by interacting with him.
Obviously, that's not your inner dialogue, that's system.
The man with the unimpressive beard notices you approaching. He drops the ledger he was holding and turns to the lieutenant.
Mr. Gart, right?
The lieutenant glances into his little notebook.
Yes.
He responds tersely.
I am Kim Kitsuragi from Precinct 57. This is an inter-district investigation, so joining me from Precinct 41?
He looks at you, realizing he still doesn't know your name. The Harbinger of Ruin. What is gold and orange like a forest fire but smells like liquor? I'm currently in between names. I think we should go with what is gold and orange like a forest fire but smells like liquor.
Are you kidding me?
No, man, help me out. What is golden orange and smells like liquor? Kim is about to say something. Let him.
It's you. It's obviously you. You smell like liquor.
And you're orange.
See? Everyone agrees it's your color scheme. We're on the right track with this name thing.
Is this what you get when you call the police now? We've been waiting for a week here.
Sir, I understand your concern, but we are here to do a job. And for us to do it, I need you to stay calm.
Yes, of course.
He takes a step back.
I know it took us a while to arrive at the scene, but it also took you a while to call us. It was you who placed the call, correct?
No, I only just got here. It was probably Sylvie who called you. She usually works the bar here. I'm only temporarily taking over her duty.
Do you have her number?
As a matter of fact, I do.
He looks behind a pile of coasters, finds a slip of paper, and hands it to the lieutenant.
You said you just got here. From where? Are you a local?
What, of Martinez? No. I live in Jamrock. I only sometimes come here to keep an eye on the place. This is just one of the many, many cafeterias I manage.
But you still know your way around, yes? In case we need direction.
Yes, I know where some things are, but as I said, I don't live here. I just used to work here. And I'm not going to start working here again, if that's what you think.
I didn't imply that. Detective.
He turns to you.
He probably means this is where you step in and ask your questions.
No, I'm good. Yeah, we're going to ask questions,
his
sure.
His face expresses profound doubt in your having this.
Behind this building, there's a courtyard. They hoisted him up on a tree there.
He points to the kitchen behind him. And how do we get there, then?
That's easy. See that door there?
He points
first
to the wires, west.
Then to your right, you should see a big hole in the fence. A really big one. You can get to the courtyard through there. No need for the keys. The hole is big enough for the Franco-Nigerian cavalry to fit through.
Who killed him?
I don't know who killed him. I'm not the police. That's your job.
Did you kill him?
What are you, crazy? Of course I didn't kill him.
Yes, Melantro, that's what she means. Why did Sylvie go away?
She went away because none of your business.
Oh, that's funny. What an asshole.
Have they not been telling you you're a cop?
Am I not a cop? Everything is my business.
Okay, you got me. She went away because of the dead body out back. And because I asked for her number. That's why Sylvie went away. Hope you appreciate that.
Thank you.
The lieutenant says. He opens his little notebook at the cover. The number is safely tucked away in a small pocket.
I asked an employee out. She didn't want to come, but felt obliged to. It was a bad idea. Now, what is so goddamn fascinating about that for you? But nothing to do with the lynching.
This stuff gets on my nerves. I'm a feminist. I guess I like to be thorough. Everything has something to do with everything. I don't know. I just went for it. You're right. I probably shouldn't have asked. Everything has something to do with everything is how I'm going to respond to this.
Good for you. Was there something else? I'd like to get back to what I was doing.
Let's go.
Not so fast. You owe me 130 real.
I don't owe you shit. what's Real, or he could Savoir Faire for medium difficulty and slip away unnoticed. This is a red check. It cannot be retried.
Oh, excuse me. You owe me 130 real.
He pronounces the R with a mock aristocratic accent.
The IIR, or Interisolary Real, is the global reserve currency. Whatever part of the world you're in right now, it's safe to assume he means you owe him some money.
Wow, you're a genius. Yes, that's right. Money. You owe this establishment 130 real. Let's see. Three nights at a tariff of 20 real comes to 60 real. Then there's the window you annihilated. The hole in the window was the first thing I saw when I came to work. So don't try to tell me you didn't. That will be 40 real in damages. Another thing you've annihilated is half the bar. You've run a tab of 30 real. Actually, more, but we'll round it down to 30 for your hard work maintaining the stability and Revachol. That's 60 plus 40 plus 30 equals 130 real. And yes, real is still money. What are you, a philosopher?
Actually, I might be.
Money is what grown-up people use to pay for things like this hostel room or eight bottles of potent blend.
Nice.
And nine packs of royal.
Nice.
We use it for everything, really. Yes, it is. No, you see, that's 40 cents. Cents are a form of currency 100 times smaller than the real. I'm not even going to take this. Come back when you have 130 real.
The cafeteria manager stands silently. Look, isn't it evil? The order of magnitude between what is asked of a person and what they have.
It does, doesn't it?
There's a shuffle of nylon as Lieutenant Kitsuragi looks for something in the pockets of his orange bomber. That's Cop 4. I haven't offered to pay because I don't have any money either.
I'm sorry, but he has to pay. I can't let him stay here any longer if he doesn't. If he doesn't have the money by tonight, then...
Officer, maybe you are better off working this from home for now. You live in Jamrock, right? It's not that far away.
Isn't there somewhere else I can stay around here? I don't have a home. I don't remember where my home is. Fuck this place. I'll take my chances on the streets. I'll see what I can do. Why do I really want to say, fuck this place, I'll take my chances on the streets? And is anybody surprised that I want to say that? What do you think? You guys think that I'm... that sounds like something I would say?
No, don't. You really need to take this up with your station. I have a shortwave radio in my car. Call them, ask for assistance. We have to get this investigation started now.
Good luck.
Alright, so we gotta pay for the damages. We knew that was gonna happen.
By the way, where is home? The address is coming up blank, and this place sure isn't it. But you've been at this hostel cafeteria for only 3 nights. Where were you before? You had to be somewhere. Why did you say that?
The name must have a meaning for me. Lieutenant Kitsuragi, do you know a place called Marvel Hill?
No. But isn't that a saying? Up on Marvel Hill, A great high place. One that is impossible to climb back to.
That doesn't sound like some way you can study if you run out of money.
I could trace the way back somehow to the exact street, the exact number on a building. I'll live in a dumpster. I don't care. Fuck everything, hobo cop. Hobo cop. No, we're okay.
You can try. Run some addresses in your head when you get the time. Maybe a street or an apartment will appear.
Yes? What do you want to know? Maybe you can.
Let's learn a little bit about the case.
To help me narrow it down a bit. Then you are not that far behind, actually. Do you want me to brief you? 3 days ago, the RCM emergencies desk received a report about a security guard who was found hanged in Martinez. An anonymous caller said there was a dead body behind the Whirling and Rags hostel cafeteria. The cadaver had been there.
Who's thanks for lurking over on the kicks? To investigate.
During that time, the victim had been stripped of his belongings. The caller did not identify him, but used the word lynching. There is an ongoing labor dispute between the local dock workers and the logistics company, Wild Pines. I was told we should approach the death as part of this dispute.
Wait, does the briefing say who the victim was? Why didn't we know anything about the caller?
A security guard or worker of some sort hired by Wild Pines. This was just hearsay from Martinez. We need to find out the truth. They didn't identify themselves in any way. The tone was muffled using a device of some sort. The desk could identify neither the caller's age nor sex. There's a strong prejudice against involving the RCM in what's seen as union matters. The dock workers' union is the de facto police in Martinez. Now it appears they've started executing too. We cannot allow that.
Hold on, and the RCM is? Of course, yes, I understand everything now. Let me just make this perfectly clear. Our job here is to find the killer. I still don't understand anything.
That's us, the Revachol Citizens Militia.
Ah.
We're the police in this city.
The RCM, or the Revachol Citizens Militia, is the police force you and him are part of. A self-organized peace corps of the occupied city of Revachol. The RCM operates within a legal twilight, yet its authority is rarely questioned. It's super useful to know this.
That's right.
So we got 10 experience for following in that conversation. Which is why I wanted to talk to him right away.
You mean like a brief? You want me to brief you?
Okay.
There's no reason. 3 days ago, the RCM, during that time, the victim had been stripped. Okay, then. Was there anything else you wanted to know?
Would you say this is a mysterious case?
No. Not a particularly mysterious case.
Why not?
The deceased is a security guard for a corporation involved in a labor dispute. It doesn't take a DeLorean polymath to put the pieces together. I just don't see the case getting more mysterious than that.
I was thinking something otherworldly might be involved. You know, something supernatural. White male in his 40s. What more do you need? Personally, I think labor disputes are very mysterious. Okay, so the case probably isn't mysterious, but could it be sexy?
There was some interest in this case at my station, but not for the reasons you have in mind. You seem to wish there was a...
Maybe there's a young woman involved. Are you sure there's not some sex angle we should be considering? Oh, I guess that settles it then.
Good point. Martinez is famed for its occult sex murder rites. We'll get on it immediately.
The weary tone is the surest indicator that the lieutenant is being sarcastic.
You're being sarcastic, aren't you? Wow, really? That's mega sexy. It doesn't have to be a sex cult, or a cult. It can just be a sex murder. It doesn't have to be a murder. It can just be sex. I'm gonna go with 3.
That's commendable. Was there anything else?
It can still be an otherworldly sex mystery. With a dark twist, even.
Oh, no.
He's basically challenging you to sex it up with some lurid twist. Don't get right into it. Sit on it a bit. Then hit him with it.
I'm afraid you and I are pawns in a pissing competition. You don't know.
His eyes narrow.
I assumed you were in on it.
You know what I'm in on? Retrograde amnesia.
Better still than an imbecilic cop-off.
Cop-off?
It's just stupidity. We shouldn't waste any more time on it. If you want my take, ask me after we've inspected the victim.
You should tell me now. This seems relevant.
Later. Is there anything else you wanted to know about the case?
Yeah, we're good.
Good.
I think you should know that I can't remember anything. I want to talk about you. You seem to be following me.
No response. He just arches his brow. He's having trouble processing it. Believing it, even.
I feel like I must repeat this. I don't remember anything. There was heavy drinking involved.
Have you tried concentrating on something other than your personal affairs?
There is a sudden, harsh edge to his voice. Like he's tired of hearing about your personal affairs.
What's wrong with my personal affairs? So what should I concentrate on? But I'm completely lacking in basic information about even this organization we're in. Can you help me? I'm afraid this is a medical situation. Or fine. Yeah, I got lacking.
We should get through this day first. Off hours begin at 9 p.m. If you're still having trouble then, I can give you an orientation. Not a fan. It's just the nature of lieutenancy.
The RCM deploys a self-styled structure called the Decomtage as its chain of command. Every lieutenant is responsible for 2 sergeants and 8 officers. That means the average lieutenant has to deal with quite a few personal affairs. Even you know this.
Try work. The case at hand. It can work miracles. Really? You look fine to me.
I'm talking serious, unbelievable damage here. I saw myself in the mirror and had no idea who I was.
This psychodrama is unbecoming of an officer.
Clearly, he prefers to think you're malingering. He cannot fathom that anyone could drink so much as to retroactively erase their entire life.
It's not psychological. Some sort of major brain damage has occurred on an unprecedented scale.
Then you should consider seeking medical attention. You can use the radio in my kinema to call your station's lazaret. Was there anything else you wanted?
We don't need to do about the case again.
Me?
Yes, you.
I don't see how my life is pertinent to the investigation.
We'll work better together if we have more rapport. Come on, Lieutenant, open up a little. You're right. What's there to know about a lame binoclard?
That's a fair point. All right, for the good of the investigation, what do you want to know?
You're wearing glasses.
That's correct.
You feel a slight urge to put the lieutenant down for this. But you can't quite muster enough testosterone.
I guess you don't need glasses. That's because I'm half Seolite.
Seolite?
My father's father was from Seoul. So was my grandmother, from my mother's side. It's not an interesting topic. It's a part of the world, officer. A geopolitical entity and a geographic division. I told you it wouldn't be interesting.
Seoul is a protection.
This is why I took Encyclopedia. You'll learn more.
West of the Insulindian Isola. Actually, it's quite interesting. Some would even say mysterious.
You're barking up the wrong tree. I don't speak a word of Seolite. I've never met either one of my grandparents, and I've never been to Seoul. I'm a regular Reva Chollière. No.
Okay.
Your brain sends the signal to your lips, but they refuse the order. Something is paralyzing them. You're pretty sure it has something to do.
Something the matter, detective?
What's going on? It's like you're a puppet in his hands. The lieutenant relaxes his eyebrow, and you seem to regain control of yourself.
What do you mean?
You know, when you're thinking, do you ever have conversations with, like, your brain?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
The lieutenant's conceptualization skills must be rather rudimentary. The lieutenant is a police officer of the old school. His concerns are material and extrinsic. But this isn't an old school case.
I get it. You're one of those old school detectives, not respectively. So how do you, you know, tap the side of your head? So you're saying your brain never just chimes in with advice or warnings or anything. I'm gonna do the old school conceptualization.
So what? That makes you the new school? God spare us. For real detective work, nothing beats a good notebook by your side.
The lieutenant produces his small blue notebook and idly thumbs through a few pages. We all have our different mediums. His is written.
Good. Let's change the subject. Excuse me?
What if I want to work this case alone? Beat it. You're cramping my style. Nothing, just an observation.
You have a distinctive way of walking. If I were to walk in front of you, we would surely collide. I hope you don't take this the wrong way. It's just a collegial observation. In the 57th, we call it the Jamrock Shuffle. Officers from Jamrock's 41st Precinct tend to move a bit erratically. They say it's a scene-clearing technique developed by one of your lieutenants for gathering evidence. It's erratic, yet thorough. Prioritizes containers.
That's racist. I don't prioritize containers. Oh my god. Yeah, we're gonna be completely ludicrous.
It's just a stupid interdepartmental thing. I'm making assumptions. We should move on.
Passing along frivolous interdepartmental stereotypes is not usually his oeuvre. He regrets bringing it up.
So he made him feel like a douche. That's good. Auto saving time. No, I didn't want to talk to you. I wanted to go through that door. You're in the way. Oh, closed for the winter. We gotta go out this way and then around the side. Ooh, what's this over here? Bottle of rum. Oh, come on, man. Why would you do that? It's alcohol abuse. Oh, wait. We didn't talk to her after meeting up with Kitsuragi.
Hello, sweetie.
Wait. Who's sweetie?
Who's sweetie?
Why, you are, officer.
Maybe I am.
And have you found anyone to be sweet to?
No, I'm done with mating rituals this time around. I don't know, wink, maybe I have. I had once, wink twice, but then I lost her. Lost her. I don't really want to talk about that right now. Yeah.
What was with that fucking wink?
Stop winking. Tap yourself on the side of your head to correct the malfunction. Do nothing. Neurological damage is probably permanent.
I see you are still grieving. Well, I won't pry.
Paying no heed, she smiles gently, paying no heed to the inexplicable winking.
You must forgive me. I'm getting so scatterbrained. I completely forgot to introduce myself.
She claps herself on the forehead.
I'm Lena. My husband Morel and I are staying with our friend Gary just down the street, but I come here for tea when they're away.
Her eyes glitter over the rims of her glasses as she looks up, smiling.
This Lena is wacky enough for the Motley Crew. Hire her on the spot.
You seem to be in a chair. How'd you like to roll at me? I don't know if you've noticed, but I don't know where I am or what I'm doing or anything. Sweetie needs money. Do you sweeties get money? Or do sweeties get money? I've got to get going now.
Oh, sweetie, I heard your conversation with the manager about your financial troubles. When do you get your next paycheck?
What is a paycheck? I haven't seen any paychecks. Or we could roll the dice and have a medium shot at tug on her heartstrings. I haven't failed a roll yet. I'm kind of scared because I feel like I'm due to fail a roll here. Pretty sure. What do you think? Roll it up? And we might be able to come back to that.
You must be joking. Although our pay does sometimes feel like a joke.
It's not easy to assert your right to a decent living wage when you don't have a strong union behind you. Maybe you should talk to Everard, the union leader.
Interesting idea. This Everard sounds powerful. Maybe he can wrangle some coins out of his pocket. Try to force a tear out of your duct. Really rip into the whole emotional aggression thing.
Officer, get a hold of yourself, please.
Now, that sucked. I probably shouldn't have rolled the dice there.
Sweetie, I'm sorry, but I think you need more help than I can give you. Oh, no, I'm so sorry. I don't have money for you. If there's anything else I can do for you, just ask. Yes, officer. You look rather dazed. Like a stunned fox. But surely things can't be that bad.
Her eyes follow your movements with some concern. I drank so hard I forgot literally everything. I hope you're right. I hope it's not too bad. Or, yeah, I'm blowing this whole thing out of proportion. Forget I said anything.
Oh my.
Takes a moment to process. Right? The Whirling Rags cafeteria, it was on my keys.
That's right. And where is the Whirling and Rags cafeteria itself located?
In Revachol?
Yes, indeed. We are in the fine city of Revachol. Yes, great. See? We're getting somewhere. What else do you know about our city of splendor? Pattered as she may be.
I don't know, diddly squat.
How would I even begin to tell you? Revachol is the most beautiful city in the world. We're fortunate to be here, you and I. I haven't seen very many other cities personally, but everyone says so. Revachol is a rare jewel. This city used to rule the world, though it has seen better days.
There's a pause as she studies your expression. You must look quite lost.
Speaking of history, you know what year it is, yes? That's right, dear. How splendid. Here, take this pen. Knowledge should always be rewarded.
Her relief is palpable. She was getting pretty worried about you there, but now she relaxes her shoulders.
I can tell that this is taxing for you, so I'll just ask one more question. What regime are we living under? What mode of government?
What kind of democracy? Some kind of democracy, maybe? I'd like to think it's the dictatorship of the proletariat, but something tells me not. Our leaders are fierce warriors who traverse the plains on steeds. Civilization cowers before us. We are governed by intelligent machines that perform calculations to determine the freest market Everyone hustles and grinds like a badass visionary. Radios are being used to control people's minds and distort our perception of reality, concealing our true masters, foreigners, and women. Cop. We are living under the cop regime. I'm gonna go... I'd like to think it's the dictatorship of the proletariat, but something tells me not. That's what I'm gonna go with.
Oh, sweetie. It's really not. There used to be people who thought that way. Other people who wanted those things, but they all went extinct. Revachol is a zone of control led by an alliance of foreign powers called the Coalition. We have almost no government of our own, and certainly no dictatorship of the proletariat.
But they still have cops.
If there's no government, how come there are cops? I don't even know what to say. I'm so disappointed.
Oh, dear.
She shakes her head, suddenly very worried.
There aren't any cops in Rivershall, not in the traditional sense. The status of law enforcement has been a complicated matter since the revolution. But we should stop for today, sweetie. You look like you need a break. Besides, I'm not the best person to explain the big things to anyone.
She's scared now. She's realized you really are brain damaged.
A defeat, I'm afraid. The people of this archipelago tried to build something new.
Brain damaged.
The rest of the world didn't like it, so they came and ended it. This was 42 years ago.
What does that have to do with there not being any cops? But I'm a cop, whatever it was, hasn't stopped me.
Of course, sweetie. I really don't know how to explain it better. You were doing quite well up until the end there. It does look like you're having trouble remembering things. History and places. Remembering reality in a word. It's very odd.
A sigh. The lieutenant buries his nose in his notebook.
But maybe a fresh set of eyes is what the world needs. And while I'm no doctor, such bouts of amnesia are often temporary. So I wouldn't worry too much. Someone more educated in sweeping matters. Maybe you should ask.
No. I'm not an encyclopedia. I won't be a guide either. I'm a detective.
Of course. Then, I don't know. Someone rich, maybe? Wealthy people are educated. Though, I don't know where you would find a wealthy person in Martinez. Yes, dear. I'm a paraplegic.
A paraplegic is someone limited or no ability to use the lower half of their body. Paraplegia is caused by spinal cord injuries, like falling from a great height, or a grenade explosion.
No, dear. I'm not quite that old. Although, I was injured in the line of duty. Nothing so glamorous, dear. Though, when I was young, I dreamt of planting the Revacholian flag on some figurative peak.
What'd you do then?
I was a training and development manager at a rapidly expanding mail order shoe company. You'd think it would be a safe job, but I had to be everywhere and, well... Once I happened to be under some faulty scaffolding. I was lucky. This was almost 20 years ago, and I was compensated exceptionally well. One can only dream of such payoffs nowadays.
I'm sorry, it was rude for me to bring up your wheelchair.
I'm used to people asking.
So roll with me. What do you mean? I want you to be my wheelchaired partner in fighting crime, ridding backyards of corpses. Catching sequence killers. Nothing. I was thinking of the lyrics to a song. Wanna roll with me?
Ah, yes. Probably Roll With Me by the Fletchers. People often quote the Fletchers at me. Morel says it's my theme song. Of course, dear. Good luck with your case.
In the wave, the send-off. Pinball machine's unplugged. Well, that sucks.
Before you stands a motor carriage. The bodywork is covered in blue and white livery, bearing the number 57. Vapor emanates from the large engine on the back of the vehicle. It hasn't had time to cool off yet. This must be the infernal machine that tore you from oblivion. The Caprice Kinema motor carriage. In the cabin, you are welcomed by a set of steering levers, a radio microphone on a hook, a pull-out toolbox under the seat, and the soft glow of the fuel preheater gauge.
Well, first things first, pick up the radio.
Lights up, and a green button labeled Prime Line glows like a feline eye. And then the soft purr of electrical kittens, radio waves cast far and wide over the metropolis. A woman's voice greets you through the static.
This is Precinct 57. Hello, Lieutenant. How may I assist you?
Hello, Alice. Please assist our colleague from the 41st precinct here. I'm putting him on.
Come in, dispatch. Come in, dispatch. Come in, Delta 10. This is Firewalker. Copy. Hi, Alice. This is the officer from the 41st precinct speaking. Nice to meet you. Yeah, we'll go with that.
This is Officer Alice Demetri, Precinct 57. How may I assist you?
Could you connect me to the 41st precinct? I have something I need to report. I need to connect me at, I was told I need to connect to my station, the 41st Lazarus. I need you to connect me to a civilian, a Sylvie. She may have reported a murder. Yeah, we're going to go ahead and...
Just a second, officer.
She puts you on hold, the stat crackling softly like a bonfire. After a while, you hear an old man greet you from the radio. His rattly voice is oddly familiar.
10-2, 10-5, this is 41st, come in, over.
A scrawny old man sits in a dusty cubicle, smoking, with a large white rectangle sewn on his vest. In front of him is a box-shaped apparatus with an array of wires and antennas, the radio switchboard. The man uses relay code. You got this. You're a cop, and cops know relay code.
10-4, message received. 10-5, relay message. What's your status? Over. 10-18, state your message, sir. 10-9, over. 10-4, message received. This is a very serious situation. I need to 10-22 the captain. Over.
Is it him? What does he want?
Says he lost his badge and needs to report it.
You what? He lost his badge?
Hey, who is this? I'm just gonna say nothing.
Who lost his badge?
Oh, God.
Dick fucking Mullen. Who do you think?
It's Officer Dick Mullen from the bestseller Dick Mullen and the Lost Identity.
He says, fighting off laughter.
Dick Mullen is not your name. It's the name of a fictional detective. You would not lose his badge. Defend yourself immediately. They're laughing at you.
Come on, officer, or come on, operator. Tell him to stop. This is serious. Or, haha, officer has lost his badge. Haha. Like, I'm the first cop to ever misplace his badge. Can we just move on? I want to get it reported and be done with it. I'm going to go with this one.
He says this has probably happened to other policemen before him, and laughs sarcastically.
Oh, goddamn it! Is he fucking kidding? The whole station's gonna be dicked for this.
Satellite Officer Vikmar is wondering if you might be joking, and adds that this tarnishes the reputation of the entire station. Over.
Mullen dicked us.
Mullen dicked us.
10-4, I hear you, officer. I'm just going to make a note here that you are in pursuit of your misplaced badge. Over.
Fuck me! Mac, come here! You've got to hear this! Nick Mullen lost his badge!
What's going on? Super cop here lost his badge.
He lost his what now?
His badge. He lost his goddamn fucking badge.
Could you all please just stop saying lost his badge for a moment? Enough with this now, I have other things to discuss.
Then nine come again.
They're dickheads. The animated conversation in the back is making it difficult for him to hear you.
New heights even for Captain Sober.
Ask him. Ask him if he's lost his gun too.
Sergeant Orson wants to know if you lost your gun too. Over.
Check your pockets. Check your... Holy fuck. You don't know where it is, do you? No. It's gone. It's not fucking...
Hi, Fury.
Gone.
What's going on? Welcome to the stream.
10-9, come in, officer. Did you get my question? We were wondering about your gun. Over.
We're gonna do, drama and convince them that we didn't lose our gun, hopefully.
Even nope. Before you can get the words out, everything gets scrambled in your brain.
No, of course I didn't lose my fun gun. Fuck it. I didn't lose my gun.
He says he didn't lose his gun. Or his fun, whatever that means.
Ask him to describe it. His gun. Not his fun.
Satellite officer McLean requests a description of your weapon. Over.
Oh. Request a description, huh? We'll give him one. Describe the plasma gun.
Oh, God. For starters, it's massive. Got flare cooling vents along your front and hydrogen flask sticking out, too. Whisper to Lieutenant Kim, what are you packing? It's a gun, what can I say? A regular goddamn murder weapon. You know, they are bang bang. You know how they bang bang. Look, I don't have it, alright? I don't have my gun.
He says it's just a regular gun.
Sounds like he's being deliberately vague.
Mullen has done it again.
Where's my gun?
The speaker cruelly mimics your voice.
Dear God, he lost his gun. Oh my, I can't.
This isn't really a laughing matter.
Yeah, I seen you sent something on Facebook, Fury. Appreciate you. I just got the banner.
Oh, I can't. Fuck. He lost his ass. He still got his wiener.
Are we really going to be talking about my wiener?
Ask him.
Sergeant Orson here is wondering if you are in possession of your genitalia.
Yes, I lost my wiener too. Just lay off, okay? I left it at his mom's after I fucked her ass all night. Tell him that. Oh, no. Oh, no. I don't need to listen to this. Firewalker out. Turn off the radio. Nope. I'm going to be a dickhead back.
That's a negative. I'm not going to say that. Over.
What's he saying? Share with the class.
He said he sodomized your mother.
The prick ate Mama's vanilla waffles at the captain's birthday party. Some nerve he's got.
Sure, her vanilla waffles were the only thing he ate?
Oh, God.
Shut up, Chester. This isn't funny. This is my mom we're talking about. Tell him to apologize right now.
Sergeant Thorson requested that you apologize for the claims that you made about his mother. Over.
Okay, tell him I'm sorry. It was just banter. I thought that's what cops do. Hey, if you don't like the fallout, maybe you don't fuck with the firewalker. Yeah.
Mac, he says you shouldn't have antagonized the firewalker in the first place.
The disbelief in Vic Mayer's voice is overwhelming.
Satellite officer V.
Firewalker.
I'm afraid he might be referring to himself as Firewater, sir.
Fire water? He's lost it. Fuck it. Tell him to find his goddamn badge and gun. That's the only thing that matters.
Satellite officer.
I heard him. I'm on it.
10-4, affirmative. Officer is in pursuit of his firearm.
Oh, God, I...
The man is fighting back tears.
Officer, do you need further assistance? Over. Send 4, I hear you. I don't have the authority to grant your request, but...
What does he want now?
He's asking for money.
Is he fucking kidding?
I don't think he is.
Don't give that asshole anything. He's just gonna drink it all.
Right. That's a negative on the additional funds, sir. Over.
This paramount to the investigation, they grant me more money. Please, I'm begging you here. I don't even have a place to sleep tonight. Okay, I heard you. No funds.
He says it's important to the case.
He isn't getting a red cent. You can tell him that.
Request denied, sir. Over. He says he's in trouble. Doesn't have a place to sleep.
Well, I guess he'd better crack the case before sundown, then.
Vikmar said... it's okay. You can do it, sir. Over.
What is he saying?
Did you want anything else, sir? Many of your colleagues are also here. Over.
He's trying to keep you from further embarrassing yourself in front of your colleagues.
Let us address them now, sir. Over. Okay, 10-4, sir. I hear you. Relay your question. Over.
Wait. Before you say anything stupid, think it through.
What's there to think about? I need information, not fear.
Be smart about this. Ask if he's there alone.
10-4, sir. I'm not hearing your question.
Hold on. Are you alone in that room? I need some confidential information about myself. I wanted to know if you got my badge's description right in your report. Could you read it to me? Name, rank, date of birth?
What? What is it? He's still on the line?
He wants to verify his information on his badge.
But of course, it says Dick Mullen, High General of the Revachoin Cavalry Force.
Tell him to stop wasting time.
What do you need, sir? Over. That's a negative, sir. I got 10-12 visitors present here. Over. 10-9, repeat message. I didn't get that, sir. Over.
What? What? What can he possibly still want from us?
He seems intoxicated and keeps asking me to call him by his name.
Mullen's drunk and emotionally aggressive. That's new.
Wrap it up. Don't indulge in his drunken antics.
excuse me, sir. Over.
You probably don't want to continue on this road.
Again, sir, I didn't get that. 10-9, over. 10-4, well, that's,
Does he actually want something, or is he hell-bent on disrupting our work?
He asked if he ever told me about his days before joining the RCN.
For God's sake, cut this shit out! Tell him to stop wasting time and be a goddamn policeman for a change.
Sir, Satellite Officer Vikmar says...
So, was there anything else? Understood, sir. Over.
Roger that. 10-10. Over and out.
A metallic drawer slides out from under the seat and clicks into place. The tools inside are neatly organized.
Take what you need, officer. It's going to be a long case. I'm not protective of my tools, like some men are.
He's clearly a little protective of his tools. But what can you do? Work is work. The pry bar feels nice and cold in your hand, heavier than you'd think.
We're taking the pry bar. All sorts of doors. We're taking the chain cutters. We're taking the flashlight.
Weatherproof lets you see things in the dark. The pull-out toolbox.
So we got all that done.
preheater gauge casts a warm glow on the steering levers and the radio on its hook.
This is Precinct 57. How may I assist you? It will take just a moment, officer.
Her voices fade out into the familiar radio static.
Gottlieb, what do you want?
He's carelessly chewing on a piece of hard candy.
Oh, it's you. With all the damage you've been dealing yourself with drugs and alcohol, I'm not surprised.
You're not surprised? Okay, anything else?
What else? I'm not a brain doctor. Look on the bright side, you've got a whole new life now. Use it wisely.
It's hard to say if he doesn't believe you or doesn't care.
And you survived it. Congratulations. Are you mobile? Even better. Anything else? I wouldn't worry about that. Officers your age have coronary trouble all the time. Also, death is a natural part of...
That's what they say, right? They're just going to have a heart attack.
Oh, yes. Yes, you are. Just don't breathe in the general direction of your fire feet. Actually, wait. Do exactly that. Put yourself out of your misery. Take a deep, diaphragmatic breath. In and...
You hear an exaggerated inhale and a long exhale on the other end of the line. I feel like you're making fun of me.
I'm the most serious person at the station, Detective. Now, do you have any current pressing medical problems? What? You want me to do blood work for you again? Tell you just how bad things really are across the board? You want another rundown of everything collapsing inside your body? Do that. I need to go. Some idiot has glued his eyelids shut with...
Glued his eyelids shut.
It looks like Mac Torson, but it's hard to say because his eyes are swollen.
It's not fucking cryo... Actalate. It's super glue, Doc.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, got a skill point.
Anything else I can help you with, officer? Of course. What is the number, officer?
Yes, hold on. Her number is 005.
At least it's not 8675309.
298.
Anyway, I think that's as good stop, a good spot as I need to take a quick 5-10 minute break. I'm gonna go have a smoke, refill my drink. Thanks for hanging out with me and checking Disco Elysium out. This thing's fun as hell once you get into it too. I'm glad I... So last time I tried playing this, I didn't even get the fucking flashlight. I didn't even bother. Like, I don't know if I just wasn't paying attention or whatever I was doing, but... In any event, I'm going to take a 5-minute break. Stick around, hang out until I get back, and I'll see you when I get back. Thanks for watching Serene Watcher Gaming. Be right back.
Well, I see we got a follower while I was away, Serene informed me. So I guess I'm going to have to eat a jelly bean if Volition's there, right? Oh, Vendetta Volitions. Yeah, there you are. I got to eat a stinky jelly bean for you. So let's see which color you get. It used to be two would pop up, but now it's only sending one up. So whatever you get, you get. And you get white, which should be, I don't think this is this the yellowish white. It's hard to see with this crazy neon light blinking in my face. Oh yeah, it's either the birthday cake or the dirty dishwater. So here's to you. Good luck to me. Birthday cake. Bet you all the good ones are at the bottom. We had a whole bunch of shitty ones. It was birthday cake. So yeah, we're going to continue our story. It's awesome. Finally get a good one.
Hold on, officer.
So we're going to try to call this Kim and ask her about this murder. Start slapping a marching rhythm on your thighs. Wait patiently.
Lieutenant Kitsuragi slowly begins to tap a little rhythm with his right foot.
Officer, I have Sylvie Malaika on the line for you.
Alright. I just realized. That I forgot my drink. Because it's like sticking and I want to wash it down. And I can't because I forgot my drink. Hold on. I'm not even going to go anywhere. I'm just going to be right back. Okay, oops. Sorry about that. Hey, Farrell. No, you didn't scare me away. I forgot my drink. I just ate a birthday cake jelly bean for Vendetta over on Twitch followed. So, but I want to wash it down. And we got Sylvie on the phone. A female voice greets you through static. It sounds like she's a million miles away from here. Hello, this is the police calling. I have some questions for you about your last days at work. Sylvie, I believe we've met before. This is me, a detective from the Whirling in Rags. Yeah.
All right.
She recognizes your voice almost immediately. You quit your job at the Whirling. Why? Was it you who called the police? Have you seen my badge? Have you seen my gun? I think I got everything I need, thanks. Alright.
You mean why did I leave the bar?
You can hear her tense up on the other side.
I'm not really comfortable discussing it with you, sir.
Why not?
Wait, why aren't you comfortable with discussing it with me? Okay, did you leave because of Gart? Alright, I won't push you on this. Are you ever coming back to work?
I left because I needed to get away from someone. What? No, why would you even think that? Please, don't bring Gart into this. It's none of your business. I already said I don't want to talk about this. You're messing everything up again. You mean why did I leave the bar? Honestly, I'm...
Why not?
Me, I don't know. I just... No, not me.
But why didn't you call? Didn't a corpse behind your workplace bother you?
What? Of course it bothered me. But I thought the union already knew about the corpse.
French toast and French fries? Or are the fries
delineating the fact that the toast is in fact French. What does this union have to do with anything? I meant us. You should have called the police.
No one calls the police.
You can hear her adjust the receiver in her hand. What do you mean by that?
You know, what the union says goes. People listen to them and they take care of their own, which is like everyone here.
I will ask him.
Legally, no. In reality, yes. Martinez is de facto policed by the Dock Workers Union.
No fries.
Words are not necessary to feel the lieutenant's discontent for the situation.
I didn't want to get in trouble with the others.
Push her further. Show her the error of her ways.
Let me get this straight. You ignored the law to save your own skin.
I didn't know I had to report it. I thought someone would take him down eventually.
It's a little late for tears, isn't it? Should have used them to summon the police earlier. It's okay, things happen, not really your fault. Yeah.
Yes, I know. It's just... Was there anything else? No, sorry. I don't. Not a lot of people have phones around here. Copper thieves take the wires. People don't have the money to have the cables put in again. They use the union's phone, or the one on the coast.
So the union has a phone, and there's one further down the coast. Got it.
It was someone else. We'll find them sooner or later, officer. It just might take a while.
Right.
Yeah, go on. Yes, I know who you are. You're a police officer. The law.
This exact conversation has happened before. Establishing authority before this young girl seems to have been important to you in the past. Don't go there again.
Oh, no. I haven't, sorry.
Boo.
Real police would have uniforms too, by the way. Where's yours?
Yeah.
Right. It's better to not ask too many questions. Lest people start thinking you're a cop or something.
Please, no. Not this again. Everyone saw your cool gun, detective.
She sounds exacerbated. I showed you my gun? When did it happen?
You were trying to impress some people with it. Everyone was eating, and...
She stops hesitantly, not sure if she continue. And what? What did I do? Actually, I don't want to know. Yeah.
You were waving it around in everyone's face, begging them to describe it. You said it calms you, and then you started making suicide jokes. It
got really
graphic.
Jeez.
Oh, those again. I have been trying to wean you off them.
Off of what?
You know, when you put your gun, your actual gun, on your temple and pretend to shoot your brains out, off of that, people don't like that. I remember this. You were screaming things like, my brains are all over the wall.
Oh, God.
I won't be seeing it, because these are my brains. I can't see without my brains. Very nice visuals there.
I should have killed myself. Why would I threaten to kill myself? I mean, look at this world. I would love to stay. Okay, I don't know what to say. Yes, but what happened to my gun?
No idea. All I know is next year we're waving around money instead. Saying things like, big bucks cannot lie, and guns can't buy money, but money can always buy guns.
Yeah.
It almost looked like you pawned it. But believe me, I did not ask. I do hope so. Please, don't call me again. Bye.
Yeah, we'll do a... She's ready to hang up. We'll, wait. Why does she seem angry with you?
Yes, yay. You have obviously done something to upset her at the Whirling in Rags when she was still working there.
Wait, before you go, you're mad at me, right? Tell me, what did I do? I can't remember anything.
I'm not mad. It's so drunk and so emotional all the time, and then the SCUA thing happened. Just made me want to quit.
What SCUA thing?
A stuffed bird. The great SCUA. You threw it against the wall while screaming, fuck that bird, and laughing like a maniac. I think you said it had been giving you shit ever since you got there. Didn't seem like you had fun doing it, though.
So you're telling me that I was the one who made you want to quit?
Yes, obviously. You were the worst client I've ever seen. And I have seen so many assholes in this place. I've had sailors fighting, union guys grabbing my ass, kids stealing booze. Once a guy was glued to the karaoke machine every night for 2 months. But you...
Go on, I want to know what I did.
Well, you were worse than all of them. Honestly, you were getting borderline aggressive. Even about little things like not turning down the volume at 3 a.m. I even liked one of those songs you kept listening to on repeat. No more. I hate it now.
Hold on, which song?
We Go On by the O.O. I can't listen to it anymore. You've turned it into a parody.
Sorry. Sorry about that song.
The hell with that song. Then there was your room. Your project. An experiment to see how far I can get in there.
Oh, God.
I tried to send the cleaner, but you wouldn't let me. Threatened to make me understand. I had no idea what you meant, and I don't want to know. And then you screamed something about how you're actually a real cool guy. No one knows. One of the coolest guys there is. The coolest guy in Jamrock. Something about disco, too.
Oh, God. Sounds intense.
And then I had to deal with your toilet. The one you clogged with police documents, causing water damage downstairs in the kitchen.
Oh, so we did flood the room. Okay.
I won't even mention you waving your gun around, harassing customers, threatening to sing karaoke, threatening to kill yourself.
Well, for me personally, if I was making threats like that, I think the threat to sing karaoke would probably be the one people should fear the most.
The ones I had to rent out of your toilet. Damn it, I don't remember what I did to your damn papers. I don't remember every little thing I do.
Resentment gives way to concern in her voice.
Especially when there's a hurricane loose. It's your fault for losing them. Not mine.
Something in you wants to immediately forget about this, as if there was a reason you threw them away.
Okay, I get it. I wasn't a very good tenant.
No, you really weren't. You were simply the worst.
I am truly sorry for everything, Sylvie.
God, I knew I shouldn't have brought it up. Just try not to call me again. Let's pretend it never happened.
When I spoke to Guard, it seemed like he thought you left because of him.
Wait, really? No, this is absolutely not true. I like Guard.
Didn't he cross a line when you asked him out?
No, I was actually flattered. I've always liked him. It was just bad timing, with the corpse and all that.
There's a pause. You can almost see her on the other side. The telephone cord coiled around her index.
I didn't know what to say to him later. Then you came and destroyed the place. So I left without explaining. Hold him, maybe.
I can tell him.
Okay, but please don't mess it up. Please don't take out your gun or something.
Right. Thank you for talking with me. Take care.
You hear a sigh of relief on the other end of the radio. Wordless, the call breaks. Then, the already familiar voice.
Anything else I can help you with, officer? 57's over and out.
In the cabin, you see a set of steering levers.
Let's see.
A radio on a hook. A pull-out toolbox. The white suede feels luxurious under the touch, and the metal clutch handle so very familiar in your palm.
Tap on the fuel preheater gauge.
As you tap on the gauge, the indicator pin jerks as if startled. It's in the large orange sector, indicating the engine is warm. Next to the gauge is a red switch labeled heat.
There's no use pressing the heat button. It won't start without the ignition key.
Yeah.
Translation. We're not going anywhere right now. Alternative translation. Don't even think you can drive my MC.
All right. So, after the autosave, we're going to take a look, because we did level up. Hunches and gut feelings, dreams and waking life, perception, Prisma. Ooh, I'm just gonna call you Prisma. 70 hours on this game, can't describe how much I love Disco Elysium, hope you enjoy it. Yeah, I am not quite as far as I've played into it. I've only played into it a couple hours, but I'm already doing more in this playthrough now that I understand the game, so I'm glad I didn't play into it too far. Empathy, we're good. To love and be loved by drugs. Oh, I'm sure I'm gonna love it a lot. Don't know where I'm gonna go with this, though. Think I'm gonna go with Psyche. Yeah, a flashlight and a crowbar. That's all we need. Keep the snow melts in this wheelbarrow. That's a lot of Botrix action going on in this chat. Wow. Botrix taking over chat. You sound surprised. I have some questions for you.
Of course. What can I help you with? Me? I am just a gardener.
Good to meet you, Justin. Another gardener.
I'm working.
Working on what?
I have a greenhouse in the yard there. I've been trying to.
But. Well, there's a corpse hanging from the tree. It smells pretty bad, so I have to take breaks.
There's a corpse hanging from a tree there. It smells pretty bad, so I have to take breaks.
Don't worry, miss. We are here to clean it up. We can get to work soon.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Of course. Where to? What do you mean? Yes, sir. District of Martinez.
She looks around thinking what else to say.
This intersection is called Roundabout North.
He knows where we are. Just wants directions.
The lieutenant seems uncomfortable with the level of disorientation you are displaying.
There's the pier, the Cape Side apartment buildings, some more tenements. Not a lot, really. The harbor gates? Some kind of commotion, I think. I don't follow the local politics.
She shrugs.
A fleet store, too. Some shops and a bridge. The canal bridge leads to the coast, but it's broken, I think. Some kind of accident, probably. Just coast. There's a little fishing village there, and a fish market. But that got closed down ages ago.
That's a bummer.
It's just water. No, actually, I think they call it the Martinez Inlet. There are some islands in the bay, but they're hard to reach. It's there, in the yard, right through the hole in the fence. No problem. Of course. I won't hold you back.
She wipes her brow with the canary yellow glove.
No gloves. You get the feeling that you need them. You have a dead body to deal with, after all.
Sure. Keep them. I have another pair.
Oh, that's great. She hands you rubber gloves with no visible annoyance. So we're going to go ahead and equip those so we don't get our hands all disgusting. And then... Okay, that'll give us plus one, right? What's this shit here say? Pigs go home. The street name is illegible. Goods from the lorry haphazardly littering the surroundings.
This Postle Vantore mail collection box has been heavily vandalized with graffito. A closer inspection reveals two bullet holes in the front. The box seems happy. Eat shit, pig. Fucked by the coon. And Saint G with a crown have been scribbled on it. Jenny is a whore and Bessette mailbox also.
Been there, post Leventuary mail collection box. Been there.
The mail collection box seems cathartic. Thankfully, then, so do you. You shudder, then you swallow.
Cool. Increased our morale by talking to a fucking mailbox. This book has a rose, a pistol, and a half-naked dame on its cover. On the cover stands a very muscular man surrounded in flames. This is a book about pâté. Book about the future. The government reads your mind using radio technology. A book about Boyadero culture promotes freedom and roaming upstream. This book, you don't really understand what it's about, nor does it seem important.
Hello, sir. Step right in. Store is open.
Hello.
Are you interested in a new and exciting book? It's a bookstore, sir. We sell books, postcards, and some board games.
She points at the window.
Crime, romance, and biographies of famous people.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Hold your horses, little girl. You're fooling nobody.
Don't you sass me.
Sir, are you okay?
Her voice suddenly reaches your mind.
Silently for a while now. Okay, sir. I'll try to answer. My name is Annette, sir. My mum, her name is Plaisance.
Plaisance? Plaisance.
Minding the register or organizing the stock.
The girl gazes at the window, then suddenly jolts her eyes wide as if recalling something.
Feel free to step in and browse our wares.
And you're standing out here in the cold because...
I'm signaling that the store is open.
She nods eagerly.
People might not know. They'd miss out on the crime, romance, and biographies of famous people.
Such a good trooper you are, already learning the value of hard work.
Thank you, sir. I'm happy to help Mom out with the store.
She smiles and stands up like a little soldier. What's your name?
My name is Annette.
Oh, we already did that.
Feel free to step in and browse up. Mm-hmm.
Shouldn't you be at school or something?
I do my studies at home at the moment. I have to help Mom keep this place running.
Isn't going to school more important than this? School's stupid. You're lucky not to be there. What is school, anyway?
Mom says it's necessary to do both, because it builds character. Mom says a proper worker is dutiful. That's how you get ahead in life. You succeed.
There is stress and unease behind these words. She's reciting etiquette.
Mom says it's peachy. She was a little afraid at first. There's talk about this house being cursed.
Ooh.
Behind her, the window has been boarded up. You sense the boards creaking, twisting for a second, and some kind of doubt in her tense shoulders.
Cursed? In what way?
Cursed in the way that makes them say that no business has ever really thrived here, sir. That they all go...
She's looking for the right word. Ass up?
I wouldn't really say it like that, but I guess so.
I don't think curses are real. This sounds rather serious. I should probably look into this. Narrow your eyes and look through the creaking boards on the window.
We can go into the bookstore and ask about the case. But I don't see much more to look into him.
Yes. Please do also look at our wares inside. The postcards and board games are there, sir.
What do you know about other failed businesses? How does this curse manifest itself? Mm-hmm. Stroke your chin. Enough about the curse for now.
Maybe I can tell you about some of our books instead.
We'll come back. I want to go check out this dead body. We need a bag. Once we get a bag, we can pick bottles for money. Yes, we're like hobos.
Kuno's got this.
The boy throwing rocks at the dead body can't be older than 12. This is fucked.
If there ever was such a thing as an ugly kid, then this is it. He's almost exquisite in his ugliness, like a gremlin.
Tells the other kid behind the fence. Hey kid, a word, police business. A moment of your time, please. I'm not getting into this right now.
Bad talk, pig. It's coming up strong. Throwing rocks.
Shit coming up strong. That sounds good. Joyous. You should hang out with this kid and see what that juicy shit is all about. I mean drugs. The kid's on drugs.
Kuno's riding it, see?
He wipes sweat from his bow and sends another rock flying.
The rake, Kuno! You should throw the rake at him, Kuno! The fuck? Does Kuno know what a rake is? Kuno's not a gardener. The fuck are you talking about?
He throws another rock.
Doesn't buy that shit. Fucking entrapment shit.
We shouldn't do anything. Don't tempt such forces.
What forces?
You will see.
The language these kids are using. Pure unfettered id. There will be no reasoning with those creatures.
Alright. Entertain the Kuno. Show me what you got. What you got there? What you got, huh? Show me what you got.
About the crime scene, you kids often play in this yard?
Right, pig. This is where Kuno plays with his little wooden choo-choo. What do you want with it?
I might have questions later. For now, let's talk about something else.
Yeah, whatever. Kuno doesn't give a shit.
The body, what do you know about it?
Shitload, pig. What's your question? Don't tell the pig shit, Kuno! Pig's choking! He's totally choking!
If I were to want to waste my time, which I do not, I would ask them who he is, how he got there, and the usual.
The usual being, have you seen anything out of the or have you seen anything suspicious?
Do you know who he was?
Kuno's fuckimp. Kuno uses the fuckimp for target practice.
Good lord.
He's trying to hide the fact that he doesn't know.
So you don't know anything?
Kuno knows all kinds of shit. Kuno's not a snitch, that's all.
He shakes his head, clearly offended. Into the popo phone. It's a popo phone. Do you know how it got up there?
Probably climbed. Kuno was busy down the road when that shit went down.
So you didn't see it happening?
You heard Kuno? Kuno wasn't even in Martinez. Kuno wasn't in Revachol. Kuno wasn't regional.
Oh, okay. Where'd you go then?
I don't know. Some fucking...
He looks around trying to come up with something.
Mesco, or I don't know. Some other place. Night City. Kuno was in fucking Night City.
Sure.
There is no Night City anywhere. That sounds like the name of a city.
That's a fictional city name. Night City doesn't exist. Where is Night City? Okay, about the dead body.
Why you gotta be riding Kuno's ass? You haven't been where Kuno's been. You haven't been in Kuno's head. You wanna know where Kuno was? You wanna know what Kuno's been fucking up to?
Don't tell him that, Kuno. It's lame.
This kid should get a lawyer. Yeah, you should get a good lawyer.
Kuno's building Kuno's city. Night City. Rage City. The City of Rage. That's it. And it's not lame.
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 That's the name of Kuno's city, bitch. Get the fuck off Kuno's back. This shit ain't about that.
It's impossible to deduce what it is about, at least for the moment. If it's important, it'll come up later. Focus on the case.
Just a couple of pigs sniffing around in the dirt. That seems pretty fucking suspicious to Kuno.
Yeah, you tell the faggoty, Kuno.
Looks like you're a faggoty now. Whatever that means. The suspicious question doesn't really work in antagonistic situations.
You're testing Kuno's patience, yeah?
Get lost,
Huh?
Yeah? The kingdom of Kuno? The fuck do you want with it? Yeah, whatever. Kuno doesn't give the fuck about it.
Alright, you're just making sure we got everything there.
Kuno, pig?
The boy points to his chest with both thumbs.
It's always Kuno. Never. I. Clearly the kid's using the third person perspective as a shield.
So you referred to self in the third person, Kuno, is that some kind of gang name? Got it. I had another question. We're gonna go with this one though.
Kuno doesn't do that, smile. Don't throw that bullshit at Kuno. Kuno knows you're lying. Trying to get Kuno hooked on the book.
Watch out, Kuno, he's trying to fiddle you! He's gonna put his hands on you!
The thing behind the fence starts squealing shrill and violent like a fire alarm.
Help! Pig's got Kuno! Help!
The sound gets louder as the child shouts at the windows overlooking the yard.
Help! He's got the Kuno! Help! Help! He's digging his dick out!
Escalate, Kuno! His dick is out! You're afraid!
Pigs are there in Kuno! The muddy, please!
It's full blast now. The wind carries the message far and wide across Martinez.
How did we get here? How did this happen? This makes no sense. There may still be a way out. Just appeal to his reason.
Are you high right now?
Help! Mistress, help!
He prances around, eyes bulging out of their sockets, rolling hard, yelling at the windows.
He's flashing Kuno! He's showing his genitals. If you don't help Kuno,
who
now,
put you up to this?
You know what? Kuno's doing this because he likes it, pig.
This is where Kuno establishes dominance over you. Change of plan. You can't let that happen. It will make things harder down the line. You may end up missing crucial information.
So you gotta be careful here.
Help! The pig's gagging him. Kuno,
fucking logical. Help! The logical pig is fiddling Kuno! No! Get off!
The nearly psychopathic way they can slip in and out of the act implies you're not the first victim.
You put him up to this yourself when you decided to talk to him in the first place.
Listen to your friend?
The RCM is trying to fuck.
Look.
For emphasis, a ghost is saying this. Shit-eating psychopathic ghost with an ace up his sleeve.
I know you wanted to hit me. You got that, I'm gonna fuck that Kuno up look. The Kuno's dad gets. The murder look. The rage look.
Relax. He can't read your mind. He doesn't know you were thinking that. There's a dead body, remember? That's what you were doing here. You're a cop on a case.
I can't.
His voice is so silent, it seems the words are echoing in your head, not coming from his lips.
I'm gonna fuck that Kuno up. I'm gonna shut his shit down. You know what? You should have hit the Kuno. You're nothing. You're a joke to Kuno. Kuno laughs at you.
Yeah. Kuno turned you into his prison bitch. Be in this shit with Kuno.
No, you're not. We can just leave.
Bitch, you're gonna be in this shit with Kuno forever.
A peepo is a type of hat, by the way.
Don't talk to me about my fucking peepo. Don't know where I come from. Kuno's bottom bitch.
Okay. Kuno is kind to his bitch. Ask your questions. But remember, this changes shit.
Click, 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 click.
Okay.
Kuno doesn't fuck.
Yeah, we'll just goodbye on that.
There are several footprints in the mud, left by work boots. Anywhere from 6 to 12 pairs have walked here.
Well, we got even odds at visual calculus, right?
Maybe more than 12. No, 8 pairs of boots have shuffled back and forth in the mud. 1. Standard work boot, steel reinforced toes, number 46. 2. Standard work boot, steel reinforced toes, number 44. 3. Hobnailed work boot, steel reinforced toes, number 43. 4. Standard work boot, number 45 or 46. You don't know. It's a miracle you can tell the prints apart as it is. The cold must have preserved them. 5. Another standard work boot, steel reinforced toes, number 44. 6. An aberration, light as air, even pace, same make of boot, but number 41. Impossible to tell. Could also have been an adolescent. The gait is undeveloped.
I'm pretty good at this, ain't I?
Bad. It's as if the whole world darkens. Everything else has a thin film of unimportance on it. And the tracks burn in the middle of it, in a strange, beautiful way.
Count the rest.
7. The glowing outline of a standard work boot, number 46. But the imprints are twice as deep as the others. The weight exceeds...
Oh, hey, Zeramux. What's going on, buddy?
8. And yet another standard work boot, number 44. There's an aberration in the pattern of the sole, however. The right sole is smoother, more worn.
How many?
8.
I was pretty off then. I counted 20.
Same guys are going back and forth, fool!
Hyperopia. Do you see anything out of the ordinary? A woman? Or a kid? Okay. How do you know?
He knows it's hard to discern sex from a person's gait.
Understood. Anything else? 200? Would it be the combined weight of two people, one carrying the other who's tied up? Let's say a heavily built worker carrying a similarly built, maybe dead man.
Could be.
He might be right. 200 kilograms of living weight is unlikely.
Possibly, yes.
But why?
You're thinking, why did they have to carry him?
Yes, they could have used a makeshift stretcher or just march him up to the gallows.
Maybe the victim refused to walk on his own, or walk to his own lynching. Maybe the victim wasn't conscious, which is what I'm going to go with. Or reading of these prints could be wrong.
Even easier to carry on a stretcher, or between two men. Anyway, it's for future consideration. What else can you see? Interesting. Let's name it the Old Soul.
Do you have any ideas, Lieutenant?
Someone operating a workbench with a pedal? Like a joiner at the harbor. Or maybe a drummer?
A drummer? That's stupid. So one of the people we are looking for is a drummer?
No, it's not. Forget I said it. We are not looking for a drummer. Perhaps it could be a driver. Driver would wear out the right shoe before the left. The accelerator is on the right.
That was actually interesting, if only I had come up with that idea. Nod thoughtfully.
We should keep our eyes open around the traffic jam. See whether anyone strikes out as a potential suspect. Seems prudent, no?
Mm-hmm. The lieutenant writes down the information down his notebook, then reverts to the tracks of Muds. How old do you think these tracks are? Maybe.
7 days would fit the time frame provided to us by the caller who reported the hanging.
It is not impossible.
How do you know?
I pulled last week's forecast for coastal Havashon. 7 days below freezing. The day before, the day of his hanging, was the last warm day.
Correct again. Sub-zero temperatures would preserve the tracks in a good state. The commotion here could have taken place a week ago.
What do you think happened here?
What do I think? A mob of people brought something heavy to the tree. One of them was carrying the victim. They shuffled around, especially under the tree. Then, after hoisting him up, they stood in a semicircle facing his direction. At first glance, this appears to be a lynching.
Indeed. They all stood in a row here and looked at the tree. Yes, everything fits so well. Carried him over, hoisted him up, watched him hang. This is easy. Isn't it strange to have your assumptions confirmed like this? This is what someone whispering suggestions in your ear would like you to feel.
We should withhold being content. I think we have a firm understanding of what happened here.
Do you think there's something we are missing?
Yes, we should have another look at the tracks. Not everything fits too well. We should just generally withhold being content with life. It's a philosophical disposition we should have.
His eyebrows arch. They are the liveliest part of his otherwise quite inexpressive face.
Is that so? Well, okay, I guess. If it helps with the police work, by all means. Do you see any...
We've been through all of it. Smells like spoiled meat and curdled dairy a human being decomposes. What's this thing up here? The winch mechanisms have been oxidizing for some years. Pills and some coins. Healing magnesium and some 20 cents. Can't get to that. Someone trying to grow herbs in this greenhouse, that would be... Kids' ladder is rickety but still climbable. Ladder's for kids that wouldn't hold the weight of a grown man.
The corpse looks at you with bulging white eyes. The face around them does not look human. It's swollen and ready to burst. His lips are fish-like and his tongue like a ball gag in his mouth.
Yuck.
You seem to be holding your breath. A cargo belt twists his neck at an unnatural angle. The body below appears stiff. It's letting out an ungodly rot. The smell seeps in even through your clenched nostrils.
So, God, why is it... Yeah, we're not going to roll endurance. God, what is that? Why is it so bad?
Active decay. It's okay to throw up, officer. No one is judging.
He's about to blow! Cops gonna blow, Kuno!
there he still is, looking right through you with his white eyes. The body below is entirely dedicated to that corpse smell.
All right. What's in here?
This trash container is locked. The sliding lid has a padlock that says, "Whirling in Rags." There's something in there, not necessarily connected to the case, but still.
Why am I looking at you, trash container? You're just a trash container.
Well, it is a container. Maybe you're prioritizing it.
Lieutenant, what do you think could be in here?
Trash? Food waste from the cafeteria? They lock these containers to keep the derelicts from flocking in. Be evidence, too.
Seems like a reasonable assumption.
We could try using a pry bar, the one you took from my motor carriage, or...
Or, Lieutenant?
We could ask for a key from the manager of the Whirling in Rags. He probably has one.
He might also have information. This is better than the pry bar idea.
Right. So we're going to go back to him. We have a message to deliver him anyway. This dude's been hanging for a week, so we can leave him for the time being.
Can I help you?
It's a trash container out back yours.
Mine? No, it belongs to the Whirling in Rags.
Thank you for clearing that up. Why do you keep the container locked?
Why? To keep the hobos and drunks out. That's why. And the neighbors too. They put their trash there and they don't pay for the garbage company.
I thought as much. And are you the only party with access to the trash container?
Well, yes. Us and the garbage disposal company.
It seems a little callous, doesn't it? Something stirs in you. Prod at him and find out.
Doesn't it seem callous to you, guarding even your leftovers from the poor?
Callous? What are you, Krasmazov? Almost all establishments in Revachol keep their trash locked. The Whirling in Rags is not special in that regard.
Krasmazov, nom de guerre, was an economist and a historical materialist. He was a leading figure on the Grad side of the Centennial Revolution, where he headed the nine-day government. Mazov is considered the father of scientific communism, Mazovian thought, or Mazovian...
The voiceover said nine-day government, but if you read it, it says 11-day government, so that's a misnomer there.
No one was implying you were, officer. Where were we?
What do you need them for?
It concerns the case. Please cooperate.
Just bring them back once you're done, please. Wait, what? But what about the bird? Yes, the bird. I found it lying on the floor with a broken wing the morning she left. You broke the skewer!
I assure you, it was him.
Why on earth did you have to break the skewer? I can't believe it. I was so sure it was Sylvie. Even worse, I thought she was trying to send me a message. Symbol of hope and all.
A tender type of hope. Something stirs in you. Perhaps this is why you broke it.
All right. Did she say anything else? About me, you know? Did she say anything about me?
She said you're nice, but also her employer. I mean, come on. The power vertical here. No, we didn't really talk about you. She said she was flattered. It was a bad timing.
Ready?
Yeah.
I should give her a call then. Thanks, I guess. Was there anything else you wanted, or... What thing? Yes, not the whole damn Union, thank God. Just the nastiest and loudest faction. They come here in the evenings. Dumb,
unreal. Time is it 12:53 in day one? Shit. We have 60 cents.
They're good customers.
Which is nice.
They place big orders and always pay on time.
We should find out who this Lord faction is occupying the booth. Lordness means talkative, and we need info. We don't. We have to wait. They'll show up sooner or later. Men get hungry, even striking men. If not today, then they'll be here tomorrow.
There are these things called days. You sleep between them. He's saying they'll come after you've slept. Just making clear you got that.
What are you, a cook now? That's none of your business. He wasn't pan-fried, he was lynched. What could the kitchen possibly have to do with...
He changes his mind.
Fine, okay. The kitchen is closed until 1 p.m. because the cook is working. You can snoop around after that, if you must. What?
By the way, you should come back to this thing-based questionnaire if you see anything interesting in the whirling later.
So in 4 minutes, we can go over to the kitchen and inspect that. Not quite up to another level. Alright, let's go out here in the time that we have and open this box with this key and look through this some trash. And maybe we can garner some more information or possibly an item. Maybe my badge is in there.
This trash container is locked. The sliding with a well-oiled crack, the lock pops open. Don't. Maybe you shouldn't.
Then I just have a premonition that there's something in there. Open the lid.
The smell of rotten food rises to greet you. You see soggy cartons, dirty rags, and organic waste.
What command?
We're just in time. This hasn't been emptied for over a week.
You see, milk, an egg rest with one broken egg in it. Some pasta wrapper. Picking up the soggy packages somehow feels familiar. You've done this before. The movements are recorded in your elbows. The methodology in your fingers. You're used to this. No, searching for evidence in the trash.
Oh, the box yeah.
Falls into pieces in your hands. Batiste Soleil cereal. There are plastic pasta packages below.
Yeah, to be perfectly honest with you, it's like nothing it's cool that there's interactive shit like that, but it's a little bit like just fills up the chat and shit. It's not really, I don't know.
Among the threadbare kitchen towels, something catches your eye. A pair of denim trousers. As the legs of the slime-covered jeans begin to unspool from the garbage, a rank corpse smell fills the air.
The victim's clothes? Cadaver in odor is faint. If these belonged to the deceased, they were removed when he was still in the early stages of decay. Drop them in here, officer. Guitar marked blue jeans. Pockets. Empty. Or empty. He wore them with a belt, too. A white belt. The loops appear stretched, but...
He looks into the container.
That is missing. That's it. Do you see anything else in there? I have another bag here.
Something slimy catches your eye. A drab, long-sleeved shirt, olive-colored, appears from the food waste, dripping with pus.
Oh.
This is a military-type overgarment. No label or serial number. This is the kind of ribbed-knit shirt that's worn over light armor to conceal it.
Whoa, I said something flash across my screen. More? I had a couple things just flash across my screen, which was weird.
The rest of the rags are just kitchen variety waste. A yellow old mug that catches your eye. But other than that...
A thrown out towel mug, that's all.
All right. We should go to Gart again and ask if he knows who put the clothes in the trash. It could be as simple as someone from the hostel cleaning the yard. Or that one. I'd advise against confronting that force. Not really. All we know is the victim's clothes are in the trash. The lid was locked and his establishment had the key. It's just a small loose thread.
The lieutenant nods, then looks back into the trash container. It's just organic waste, cold and slimy on your hands. Apple and potato peels, mostly. Unidentified sludge and the occasional chicken bone thrown in for good
measure. Unidentified sludge.
Nothing. It's nothing. Nothing more to see here. What's this? A blue piece of plastic sticks out from the apple peels. It's shiny. Looks like the corner. Something larger. A clipboard. A blue plastic clipboard with moist papers hanging from it. They look badly damaged, but you can still make out forms and notes.
Those are my that's my shit.
Officer, is that your paperwork? It is. Look. The plastic has the RCM street read on it.
Another skill point.
Form in there. If you don't mind my asking, how could you have let your paperwork end up in the trash?
It has a verbal inequality. Maybe I needed to lose it for the great bloodletting to begin. Must have been cramping my style. I think I didn't want to be a cop anymore. That's why I tried to flush my cop life down the toilet. I'd rather not talk about it right now.
Well... lucky we found it. You should take stock of what remains, just to be sure some has not made it into the hands of the RCM's adversaries. Organized crime and the like. There might have been police secrets in your notes.
Okay, I'll do that.
It would also not hurt to start taking notes on the case. Now, tell me what your eagle eyes see. Or are we finished?
Some items, such as the ledger you found, are interactable. Go to your inventory. And select the
ooh, Lauren Shay with the follow. Good lord. Well, guess what I gotta do? Oh, there's another one and another one. All these follows. Keep them coming. I'm gonna eat all these jelly beans. There's Lauren's. Darley gets one too, if I can get these fucking things out of here. Well, there we go. Alright, Lauren. For you, I am eating a brown jelly bean. Liver and onions, or a cappuccino. Fucking liver and onions. Oh, God. Son of a bitch. Hold on a minute. Nope. Oof. Why am I still chewing it? Oh, God. So, Darley, you get, yours is going to be dirty dishwater or birthday cake. Thanks, Fury. I appreciate it. Yeah, I was just thinking I need more iron. I don't know if there's liver in that shitty jelly bean. Let me take a sip of this and then try the next one. Oh, good fucking lord. Alright, so this one's going to be dirty dishwater birthday cake. I got a birthday cake earlier. No, that's Tutti Frutti, actually.
So that would have been dirty socks if it was a bad one. Well, at least a good one counteracted Lauren's shit one. Thanks, Lauren. I know Serene appreciates it because now she doesn't have to eat more of these. More follows I get when she's not on stream, the better. We're almost out of them, though. Is there any way to take this fucking thing apart? Yeah, there's only like a handful in here, maybe six or seven. Good fucking lord. Ugh. Ugh. And now they're mixing together. I guess it's not as bad when they're mixed together. We're going to fish this fucking mug out of this dumpster real quick.
Of the yellow man frolicking in saffron. Only in its social sensibility.
Lieutenant briefly glances at the mug, then returns his sight to the trash.
You've acquired an interactable item. Investigate this item further by going to the Interact tab in your inventory.
Okay, so we got all the shit out of the trash. The
sounds of muffled gong.
That's one thing of the least. I think we got it all.
Yeah, meanwhile, this little prick's throwing fucking rocks at a dead body still. Yuck. Alright, so wait a minute. We leveled up. I think we needed... Didn't we need endurance to get this dude off the fucking, out of the tree? I know that seems kind of weird, but I'm pretty sure we needed endurance. Let's check that again. Fucker shit himself. There, yeah, it's endurance.
Looking right through you with his white eyes. The body below is entirely dedicated to the...
So let's bump up our endurance. There we go. I wonder if that even makes it so we can get him down.
There he still is, looking right through you with his white eyes. The body below is entirely dedicated to that corpse.
Nope.
Emitting it is all it does now.
So it's probably going to turn down to we're going to have to, like, basically extort one of these kids into cutting this guy down. Is basically what it's going to boil down to. Because what do the cops do if nothing else? Use extortion as a tactic. Really, everybody uses extortion as a tactic. So what kind of interactables? We got some pills here. There's the mug. And the damage ledger. Let's look at our notes. And we have to ask Gart first, if he knows anything about the victim's clothes. Oh, and we can look into the kitchen now because it's after 1300 hours. The dishes are drying, they smell of chemicals and pine trees.
A thin man is smoking below an exhaust hood, occasionally sipping from his mug. This must be the Whirling's cook. As you step in, he nods toward the table and says something in a completely foreign language. The only words he can make out are Garanzi and Kubek. Okay, it's definitely not his name. Whatever you do, please don't call him Garanzi Kubek. Please, it's not funny. The man puts his cup down and replies something, his left hand drawing arcs in the air. He smiles and bangs his leg against each of his pots in turn. It's almost like music, especially with the sounds of assorted dishes boiling and simmering on the stove.
Weird.
You see a heavy steel door with a prominent dimple lock. It's painted blue. You immediately feel drawn to the color. blue is for mystery.
I'll be back door, mark my words. That sounds like something I would say to a door. I don't know about all you, but I would certainly be asking, you know, talking to a door. Gotta talk to the door. Oh god, the aftertaste though on some of these fucking jelly beans. Unbelievable. Remind me to brush my teeth, babe, when I get off stream. Well, let's first touch the door.
The cobalt blue surface feels rough to touch. The stainless steel door is flush with its frame on every side. Old cobalt paint, rough on the fingers. 40, 50 years since this was painted, maybe. The door does not budge.
You do? It's a door in the back of the kitchen. Why do you care where it leads?
I'm drawn to its cobalt blue. It's part of the whirling in rags. There's something about this place that makes me want to know. Out of duty, we may find something pertinent to the investigation.
Yes. I suppose it's worth seeing if we can get in.
Yes, a mini side investigation. No, the door is a mega investigation. The door and the main investigation will merge into a stereo investigation.
Gart is the person to ask about this. The cafeteria manager.
Okay, so we gotta talk. We have a lot to talk to Gart about. Ooh, there's $1.15 up there. Yeah, let's just talk to Gart.
Can I help you? Thanks. I hope you found what you were looking for. How strange. I certainly didn't put them there.
Maybe you don't remember putting them there. Maybe you were sleepwalking or in a fugue state. Could someone on your staff have put them there? Who else has keys to the trash container?
I think fugue states are more your forte, officer.
Maybe you don't remember putting them there? Maybe just... Yeah, okay.
Sylvie had the keys before I got here, and I can vouch for her. I can vouch for all my staff. None of us would tamper with the crime scene.
Who else has the keys?
The trash collection service, CS Municipal. I don't see why they would... put anything in the trash, though.
Ah, the elusive CS Municipal. I doubt we'll be able to track down who was sent here last and when. This will have to be one of those little threads that solves itself down the road. Thank you, anyway.
Yes. Another thing. Great. I love those. Oh, yes, that door. Sure. There's nothing mysterious about it. Just a door. No, I don't have a key. I don't know how to get there. I don't care either. It's not like I've been wondering about it for 10 years. It's just a frick warehouse, probably. Or some boring storage space with a bunch of old junk and dust.
He's attempting to maintain an air of indifference. It's absolutely not convincing.
Let him get to pretend he's indifferent. I think you'll like to know what's back there.
Fine, okay, a little. But my job doesn't leave me time for wondering about one locked door in one of the cafeterias I manage. So, I haven't opened it. I have cleaned the whole place 100 times over, though, after the animals. And I haven't found a key, so good luck with that. Yes?
You see a heavy steel door with a...
Okay, so we have to find the key to that. I wonder if we can talk more to this dude.
The man ponders his cooking utensils and gives... He looks up at you, then looks away. Shrugging is an international sign for... No, I don't know what's behind that door.
So he doesn't know either. Maybe the chick in the wheelchair knows. Probably not.
Hello again.
Nope, she don't know shit. Maybe the chick upstairs knows shit. Or maybe not. It's worth checking, though.
The door is closed. There is no answer. You hear the shower being turned on. A tremendous loneliness comes over you. Everybody in the world is doing something without you. The door is closed.
Yeah, she's showering. We're not bothering. Okay, can't get in there. The radio's on, all right. Oh, that's the bathroom door that's laying on the ground like that.
Kim also tries not to look at the pile of taped viscera on the carpet, or the weird suitcase on the hat rack, or the potted plant dying in the corner. But it's all just too morbid.
I did it my way.
He nods.
No problem, officer.
That's fine. Taking him here got us some, got us some experience, though, nonetheless. I actually think I'm about ready to take my next break. I think I'm going to stay on for a while. Because I'm having a blast playing this fucking game. This game's a lot of fun. It's like playing through a fucking book that, like, everybody should read or something. That's, like, how it feels to me. It's, like, really, like, postmodern type downfall shit. Oops. We're up to $1.75.
Fuck, does Kuno care? Kuno's Kuno. You already know that slow shit. Shoot that shit at Kuno, Pig O'North. Yeah? The kingdom of Kuno? The fuck do you want with it? Yeah, Kuno doesn't know shit about that. That shit is beneath Kuno. Listen, listen. Kuno doesn't care about this small-time shit. Just listen. Kuno saw what you did there, dumpster diving. Kuno could hook you up with some sweet rags. Shit like Kuno's wearing. Your size, good price. 500 real. Look, Kuno ain't seen shit lying around. Except for that up there. Now you want performance gear or not, Grandpa?
The lieutenant remains silent. But his expression couldn't say, "I told you so," any louder.
Whatever. Kuno was trying to help you, but you're too fat for fouling anyway, pig. The fuck? A mug in the trash? Is this about the fucking clothes again?
Gotcha. So you win skins for the B-Duel game. And what? Like, you can, like, equip different skins for the B-Duel game? I don't get it. Yes, does this racist mug have anything to do with it? Yes, does this adequate depiction of a South Samaritan man have anything to do with it? Yes, does this quaint, better not taken out of its historical context must actually talking about this makes me uncomfortable. Let's get take it back. Oh, okay.
Yeah, Kuno sees where this is going. Kuno's got that fast brain. You saying you pigs are after the mug fucker because he's the clothes fucker?
Kuno. That's exactly what I'm saying, Kuno. Someone has tampered with the crime scene, cleaned some of it up.
Yeah, that's tense. Someone's going to the beatdown basement, huh? Mug guy gonna get tied to the radiator. Kuno doesn't know who put that shit in there. And if he did, he wouldn't squeal. But if you find out, maybe you can...
Tell the Kuno who it was. He's curious. He likes putting two and two together here.
Stop turning into a pig, Kuno! They're trying to get you hooked on the snitching! Get away from my Kuno!
Wow.
Yeah? Get your bacon shit away! Kuno doesn't like to be seen with the popo! Get your shit done and out of Kuno's face! Look at that fucking shit! You're trying to get Kuno killed!
So you would say that the ladder is unclimbable.
Does Kuno know? Kuno's not a fucking acrobat.
The lieutenant takes a quick note in his notebook.
It's a trap, Kuno! Don't climb it, Kuno!
Dunno. If that's Gardner used to work there.
Kipped is a pejorative term used to describe people of South Seminese or Erie Opagite descent. It used to be a common first name.
So this kid's like a little racist piece of shit, obviously.
Not so much anymore.
Gardner used to work here? You mean the young woman by whirling in rags, that Gardner?
Look, Kuno doesn't explain shit. Kuno just says shit.
Yeah, her. What was she doing in the greenhouse in March, anyway? What kind of gardening? Yes, it seems suspicious. You don't like things being like that. Suspicious.
Yeah, whatever. Kuno doesn't give a shit. The fuck about it?
Okay.
You're testing.
Get lost!
Kuno doesn't...
We're gonna talk to this little motherfucker. We haven't done that yet.
Snuff my shit out, I think. Looks like it's time for me to go, Kuno. Pig's come to take me in. I'm going away for a long, long time, Kuno. Going away for life.
What's going on there? Fuck are you trying to pull, Pig?
I come from the woods, Kutavitu. You don't want to go there with me. You don't want to see what I've seen.
Oh, man.
Don't be traumatizing here. Get the fuck out of here.
I'll die before I squeal. What's this kid shit? Fucking mind games. I'd rather die than squeal.
Get the fuck out of here, face. You got done. Talk to me.
Shut your piss hole. I'm talking.
I'll die before I squeal. Murder was the case. Was the case they gave me.
She has almost vanished behind the fence. Only the top of her hat remains.
I'll die before I squeal, Pip. You don't want to fuck with me. I got my hands bloody. I'm not here, Pig. You're not seeing this.
You can still see the top of her hat from behind the fence.
All right, let's go talk to the gardener again. Ask her about why she's got shit going on in March when there's snow on the ground.
Hello again, officer. Well, this might be the last snow we get. At least I hope so. Snow has nutrients in it. Helps everything green up in the spring. At least that's what my grandma always told me.
Yes. Think about the cute grandma, not the weird snow.
Yeah, let's do visual calculus.
Stop looking at her. Look around. What do you see? That's right. And the canal, the bookstore, the harbor gates. This is a great vantage point for keeping an eye on you.
No, of course not. I don't understand what this is about.
She looks towards the art and her expression clears.
The kid did this, right? The red-haired rat? Can't say a sentence without or kipped. He's always giving me trouble.
I was talking to him, yes.
Maybe you shouldn't be. I mean, you do your job, but that kid is beyond help, and he certainly won't help you.
You've been resting here for quite a while, haven't you?
Yes, I'm tired.
I understand. The RCM isn't welcome here, and the locals want to keep an eye on her.
There's silence. The smallest of smiles.
That's okay, Miss. Do what you have to do. I think we're done here. Go.
Fuck, does Kuno care? Yeah, the kingdom of Kuno. The yeah, whatever. Kuno doesn't give a shit. Kuno doesn't.
There, he still is, looking right through you. The smell is repulsive. It pushes in from your mouth, more instant and more familiar than anything you'd expected. More fever than odor. It fills your mind.
Protein spell.
Too late. It's impossible to keep him. Your body, until a pool of vomit lies under your feet, and your throat stings from the stomach acid.
Keep it. The hangover is clearly making this worse for you. You could use some ammonia to clear your head. That young woman, the gardener, mentioned she used salts for the smell. If she doesn't have any, there might be some in the fruit store nearby.
Acquiring ammonia will provide a modifier to the white check. Modifiers make checks easier and allow you to retry them.
Ah, okay. Got ya. Okay, Oh, you could sell this shit, huh? Probably want to sell all this shit eventually. If they got you collecting bottles and cans. Street signs reads fuck the police, yeah.
Hello again, officer. Oh, excuse me?
She's uncomfortable. Maybe you should drop this line of questioning.
Oh, well, I didn't write it there. I'm just sitting here. I don't know anything about that either. As I said, I didn't write it.
Pig is a widely used term for members of the police. It's not loving.
No need to worry. We are not saying you did.
Okay. Well, I didn't. Sure. I'm done with them. Go easy on that stuff. It gave me a terrible headache.
Alrighty. So then we go in here. think it'll automatically do it when we go to take the body down.
There he still is, looking right through you with his white eyes. The body below is entirely dedicated to that corpse.
We can't get back here.
An inconspicuous pile of the roofing material Eternite. It's nothing. Someone just left some roofing material slanted against an old shack. Because it's nice and orderly, well-laid rhythmic pattern calms your mind. Mammals like this stuff. No, there's more to this. You get this strange feeling. Hard to say. It's gone now. Feelings pass, you see. Especially...
Okay, so that's a failed check that I'm gonna have to do later. Wait a minute. Why did it not let me finish that? That's so strange. 'Cause didn't I collect my shoe? People are educated. Track down your badge. Track down your gun. Find out it's a union box. Who put the clothes in the trash? In this case needs an official name. Go to your inventory and interact with Angela or give it one. Okay. So we got to go to our inventory, interact with the ledger.
It's the ledger you found in the trash. A pitiful cabbage of white and yellow papers hanging from plastic board, barely held together by a metal clip. This sad display is made complete by the faint smell of urinal cleaner. There's a piece of toilet paper, or is it cleaning tissue? No, it's a metaphor for you. Below the pathetics, terror. Do not look into its blue heart. It's just toilet paper sticking to the back of the plastic clipboard. You can take it off if you want. Still wet, the toilet paper peels off the plastic easily. All you have to do is shake it off with your finger and voila. It now looks marginally better. An aluminium block runs the width of the board, biting down on the paperwork. Its crocodile teeth are the only thing keeping the papers together. A regular pencil, the tip worn down to nothing, as the surface is interrupted by a silvery sticker. It's rectangular, sparkling with iridescence. You don't know how you didn't notice it before. It is similar to the RCM watermark on your blazer the lieutenant mentioned. Didn't he say something about the headlights of his motor carriage? That you can read these there?
Lieutenant, is this one of the hologram watermarks you mentioned?
What? Yes, halogen watermark, used for adding information to RCM property.
Interesting.
It depends. Aside from an anti-counterfeiting stamp, mine has my station number and address. The information varies by date of issue.
Maybe yours will have how many cases you've solved. How many years you've been on the force, he's thinking. It'll have that.
Any capable light with the right wavelength will do. Yes, RCM vehicles have had lights tuned especially to reveal halogen watermarks.
This means you can read the watermarks if you just turn the lights on.
Okay.
While a bunch of sodden papers sag from the clipboard in your hand, they're not exactly white. They're yellowed in patches by sunlight and alcohol and covered in dense blue handwriting. Ink escapes into watercolor patterns, reaching its tendrils across entire pages. The paper itself is checkered with faint red lines forming short paragraphs. Once in a while, there's a red stamp that exclaims, "Case files, commit to paper." The case files themselves are plenty. You count more than 100 sodden, crumpled up, earmarked pages falling apart in your hands. They appear to be sufficiently organized and extremely dense. Work, strife, poverty, the Jamrock Quarter. These are handwritten logs of investigations dating back to January 51, this year. The exact number is hard to estimate due to missing pages and an odd naming convention. But there are at least 20, maybe 30 cases undertaken, not completed, mind you. It's the middle of March. You have attempted 2 cases a week on average.
Huh? 2 complex cases to undertake is a lot, yes. You really have to push yourself. I would not suggest it, lest you start making mistakes. 2. That's a lot. I didn't mean to say you are making mistakes, by the way. It was presumptuous of me. It's okay. We all make mistakes.
Like a fan of Gill's, the checkered papers dry in your hand. The handwriting is extremely dense, if mostly illegible.
Okay. There was mention of a naming convention here.
Yes. It appears you employ a, shall we say, robust yet literary system. Each investigation has its case number written on the margins. Yet, still more tellingly, most are accompanied by a name. A title, one might say even. One that draws inspiration from snoop fiction and vespertine cop show staples. Yes, all caps. One is called The Next World Mural. Another, The Square Bullet Hole Murders. Another yet, The Unsolvable Case. Others appear more lighthearted. The guys on a couch in an unexpected location, and the murder at the hookah parlor. Even the rare Article 3 collapsing tenement. Murder features prominently throughout. It's going to take an effort to piece these case files together, but it can be done. Once you're done inspecting them up close.
You mean the alphanumeric? Officer, precinct, time of arrival at the scene? Oh, you mean the titular? Yes, well, so do I. In our defense, almost everyone in the RCM does.
Why is that?
It's a holdover from the early days of the RCM, right after the revolution, when the organization had little idea how to do things. It persists in an unofficial capacity. Officers use these titles to refer to their work among themselves.
I seem to have named the case Square Bullhole Murders.
Again, in your defense, I seem to have named one the man with the hole in his head. That was a real person. His death was real. Still, I named it that. Amuse myself. I pray his loved ones never find out.
What happened to him?
Spiked through the head.
Oh, God.
It was a workplace accident.
There is, for precisely one more. 15 pages near the end remain untouched by the damage. The checkered grid, once all the tasks are accomplished, the case is complete. The tasks you've completed flow out of the kind green ape pen in a brash freehand similar to the rest of the letters. The wording comes easily. It's almost robotically simple, a language developed for mental rigor and simplicity. Inspect the victim's body. Interview the cafeteria manager. It's not exactly poetry, but poetry would be out of place. A satisfying slash sounds across the paper. You're done. Things to be done and things already done. The composition of reality. This is an extremely useful tool for a detective of the Citizens Militia. Now all that remains is to name the case.
No, actually. Any ideas?
Shit on a stick. No, we're gonna name it the Hanged Man.
Great. That's great. That's actually what I was thinking too. The Hanged Man. Good, strong name. We have a very good name for the case now. I'm going to start calling it the Hanged Man. It's good to be sorted without.
You don't exactly close them so much as distance yourself from the smelly papers.
Logic, can I read these files now?
From your nose now. Yes, you can piece them together using the alphanumeric code on the margin. It always begins with HDB41, then date of initialization and time of arrival on the scene, followed by the title. For example, HDB411201170, the next world mural. Why, yes, your precinct number is 41.
An HDB?
Every last alphanumeric in the files begins with it. And these are your case files. It's safe to say HDB. Are your
Horace Debbie Berenger, Hram Darjan Benzakin. Wow, I don't know what to say to that.
Nothing here either. Logic really isn't the best faculty to have this conversation with, but it's the one you got. So sorry. Yeah, we're staying out of this business for now. HDB is bad news from yesteryear. It's shit, honcho.
How long does it take to read a case?
It takes about half an hour to piece one together, using the system you've devised. Where do you want to start?
Oh my god, we're not doing that right now. Jesus. Actually, we're going to take a break right now and
a bunch of sudden
go a little bit longer, and then I'm going to cap off the stream. But I do want to take a break and come back for a little bit longer. I'm having fun moving along. I've already done way more playing this than I did the first time I tried to play this. So, I am definitely enjoying it. And I hope you're enjoying it too. And if you are, please hang out with me. Stay right here and I'll be back in 5 minutes. We'll be right back. Alright, just a quick break. We're back. But we're not going to go through that right now.
In the back, you see thin.
Reading through every file, that's not something I'm going to do at the end of a stream like this.
Bright red, all covered in boxes by marching armies. These look like official forms waiting to be filled out.
Hmm.
Then rip them from the binder and hand them out, according to type of form. Three, the topmost are misconduct fines. The middle ones are station calls. And the bottommost are field autopsy forms. Each is easy enough to make sense of. You don't have to be an intellectual giant to do police work. A monetary penalization ranging from 20 to 250 rial. Severe cases allow for 1,000 rial, but that requires special paperwork. The details of issuing these fines are spread out over the rest of the fields, but they appear pleasantly vague. These are quite sinister in turn. They give a date and time for the person to appear at the specified precinct police station. Below the call are the criminal charges you risk by not appearing.
Oh boy.
A dozen pages of thin copy paper, bright red in color. You see the parameters of a deceased human form waiting to be filled in. Age, sex, condition of internal or... Yes, all that remains now is to fill those forms and hand them to people. Fines for wrongdoers, interview requests for bad guys, and field autopsies to dead guys. The rest of the stinking cellulose is much worse for wear. The incense, it's made of dark blue plastic, hard enough to beat someone to submission with. The edges are rounded, however. The U4 size board feels thick and heavy in your hand. Light shimmers on its wet surface. On the back, you see the embossed letters RCM. Blue. The blue heart. Don't look into it. Something rattles inside, ever so lightly. Is there a hidden compartment? Permeables. It's not hidden per se. The compartment is made for permeable materials that would get damaged if something happened to it. The plastic shimmers like lapis lazuli, but it is not see-through. You cannot see to its center. With your hands, you four-sized pages hang from the clip screwed to the top of the board.
I'll take a risk.
Is not what you end up doing. You squeeze the plastic to slide it open, but nothing happens. The ledger quivers in your hand. As it shakes, the pages rustle. This pathetic mess suddenly afraid of you for some reason.
So I gotta put interfacing.
The acidic stench of rotting food is rubbed off on the cellulose. It now forms the base of the experience. This base surrounded by a faint air of spoiled meat. The stuff of death itself.
Alright. So... we have to go to the Kamina and turn the lights on.
Inside, you see a set of steering levers, a radio microphone, a pull-out.
All right. Ready? I turn, you press start.
The dashboard lights up with orange glow. The rounds per minute gauge jumps, and the engine of the Caprice kick. The lights unfold with a little click, casting electrical light onto the ground before the vehicle.
There you go. I'll turn them off from the remote once you're done. We just need to stand in front of the machine now.
As you hold your letters clip under the headlamp, an iridescent hologram appears. A street grid and the veins of a great river. A familiar sensation washes over you.
There she is. Revachol West.
There's a note of pride in Lieutenant's voice.
Around the borders of the watermark are dozens, no, hundreds of micro perforations.
Look at the street grid.
The rectangular watermark is overlaid with the logo of the RCM, and yet the major arteries of Revachol are all recognizable. They shimmer in the Kanema's headlights. A rat brazenly darts past you and disappears amongst the stopped lorries. In the distance, a child somewhere shrieks. A woman reprimands her in a voice no quieter than the child's cry.
Ah, Martinez. Let me see. Right here.
Yes, he puts his finger near the top of the map on a segment of coast jutting out on the great ocean. Seems nice.
No, it does not.
There are many of them, and they are divided into three separate rows. The first row has 18 dots. The next is the longest. It runs all the way around the border, and then some. There are so many, it's hard to count. More than 150. The last row has three perforations. That's it.
Those are perforations. They represent your record as an officer of the RCM. They are your statistics, as it were. I should have guessed you'd keep a record. Officers often do.
Alpha male officers who are proud of their numbers often do. It's meant.
The first row represents your years of service. 18 years. Okay, not bad at all. What did you do before you volunteered? That's what it says. I might have guessed even longer based on your age. What did you do all those blissful years of your youth?
Got drunk like a megastar.
Yes, that does seem quite likely. Your youth coincided with some heady days for Revachol. But let's move on, shall we? This next row, the one that wraps all the way around, is your number of closed cases. Closed is good. It means finished. You've got, let's see. Wow, more than 200. It's quite a lot, even for someone who's been on the force for nearly two decades. Usually, clearing more than 10 cases a year puts you in the 90th percentile of all RCM officers. Call it what you want. You are a valuable member of your precinct. Now, let's look at the last row. Right. Those are your confirmed kills. You've got precisely three perforations there. For an RCM officer, especially Precinct 41, which is in the Jamrock Quarter, it's rather tame. I mean that in a good way. There are certain officers who treat their kills like some kind of ghoulish game. If they do happen to solve a case, it's usually by accident. But it seems as though you are, or at least were, one of the good ones. So we have that to be thankful for. Yes. Everyone has their own method of coping. Some more effective, or some
destructive. Well, obviously, we've taken the destructive path.
Personally, I find it helps to keep up a few hobbies.
Like what?
Oh, this and that. Let's not get into it now. Why not gardening? You've already got the gloves.
It's meant in earnest. Please don't mistake it for a jab. The lieutenant nods.
Right. I'll go turn off the lights.
You can now see your statistics on your journal page, to the right of the task description.
Cool. We can do that now. We have 3 Oh, okay, yeah. Superstar Cop 2. People killed 3. Communist 2. Sorry Cop. Boring Cop. Good Cop, Bad Cop. People killed. Cases solved. Years in service 18. Okay. Gotcha. Very good.
Yes. What do you want to know? Good.
Okay, we gotta figure out how we're gonna get this guy down with our endurance solo.
Look, does Kuno care? Yeah, like a fucking volcano?
Yeah.
You were lucky you didn't die there.
Oh, what? You'll fucking vomit on Kuno too, Pig? Pig, do you have any idea how fucking stupid that sounds? Kuno's cruising his bitch on the town, and the bitch comes back griefing to the Kuno. What a...
Get the fuck out of here, fat ass! Those pants are too small for you.
Oof.
The pants are totally okay. Don't listen to her. She's trying to give you body image problems.
Kuno doesn't fucking...
There he still is, looking right through.
I mean, did I have higher endurance last time I tried to play that?
Stay away from me, pig! You don't want to...
Wow, these kids are assholes. They are ass clowns. So we're going to go into the bookstore, and I think this is where I'm going to save it and call it a stream. I hope everybody enjoyed their time with me tonight doing Disco Elysium. I think we're going to do a host on Kick and a raid on Twitter. So bear with me while I look. We'll be back tomorrow, 6 p.m. We'll be 6 p.m. tomorrow, which is Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. No, I said Twitch. Did I say Twitter? I'm pretty sure I said Twitch. Friday we will be off, and then Saturday, Sunday we'll be on. 6 p.m. every day this week, except for Friday. I think Serene might be on tomorrow, but definitely one of us will be. Like I said, we're going to be sticking with the 6 p.m. start times, and we're trying to get our viewers up on Twitch. We want to hit affiliate there so we can start doing morning streams again. Keeping everything in, getting everything up to speed over there, as we just started streaming to Twitch not that long ago. Thank you, babe. And there it is. Love it. So yeah, let's take a look at who we're gonna host to. See, we got Lauren Shea, who stopped in and said hi and gave us a follow. Maybe we should go ahead and host her out. Actually, that sounds good. Let's do that. We're going to do Lauren Shea. She looks to be hanging out. It says games, but I don't know. So we'll do that on Kick. And then on Twitch, Aquatic Wolf. Looks like he might have just started. So we're going to go ahead and, if you're on Twitch, please hang out. We're going to be raiding out to Aquatic Wolf. And if you're on Kick, hang out, and we will be hosting out to Lauren Shea. I appreciate you all hanging out with me. I'm the Watcher Prime. This has been Serene Watcher Gaming. I hope you all have a lovely evening, and I hope you come back to me for episode 2 of Disco Elysium, although I'm not too sure that's going to be on the next raid. We're probably going to take a day off of this, go into something a little bit more fast-paced, but we're definitely going to be back with more Disco Elysium, so you know, check back for that, and check back to see what else we're up to on Twitter or on any of your preferred platforms. Like I said, I am the Watcher Prime. It's been a pleasure to be with you guys this evening. Take care of yourselves. Take care of each other.
and peace.